The board found in May 2014 that Paxton was not properly registered as an investment advisor in his work with the firm. It reprimanded him and fined him $1,000. Paxton's name also appears in a federal court document as a major investor in a Dallas area firm in a U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission investigation. Court documents in the federal investigation of the technology firm Servergy do not make any allegations of misconduct by Paxton or draw links to the investigation into the securities fraud in Texas. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Now Facebook is rolling out their newest feature, LifePoint, which analyzes users' histories to determine exactly when things went wrong. The new feature combs through photos, status updates, likes, everything that you put on Facebook in order to pinpoint how someone irreparably ruined their life. For example, it might highlight your friend's spring break trip in 2003 when she took her first shot, or your cousin's engagement to a guy named Scott spelled with a K.
So, Facebook must have a lot of depressing information to work with.
Well, we look for sadness indicators, positive versus negative adjectives and status updates, whether you've liked a corporate entity such as Walmart or Arby's.
One of LifePoint's most buzzed about features is the Life Compare function, which lets you see how your mistakes stack up to others.
Here, I'm overlaying my graph with a graph of a childhood friend. You can see his life ended up much worse than mine, which is great.
Anything with a profile has a life point, so you can look forward to finding out when your favorite bands, TV shows, and companies started going downhill.
This is the Onion News Network.
It is Free Talk Live, and of course, as usual, you can bring up anything you want, though not at the moment. Right now, if you're going to call in, your thoughts need to be for Dr. Ed, and you know what? I didn't ask him how to pronounce his name, and I'll ask him right now. Ed, how do you pronounce that last name of yours?
It's Gogek.
Gogek. Dr. Ed Gogek is with us here. He is an author of Marijuana Debunked, and I got to say, Ed, I want to thank you for taking the time to join us here on Free Talk Live, because we talk a lot about ending drug prohibition here on this program, and it is hard to find anybody who's going to take the side of the status quo, at least on the issue of cannabis. And you've written a book about it. You are against legalization, isn't that right?
That's right.
Our phone number, if you've got a question for Dr. Ed Gogek, is 855-450-FREE. You can't call on Skype because that's where he is right now. But tell me, before we, you know, I've got questions for you, obviously, but give me the pitch. What's the book about, Marijuana Debunked? And I'm sure that'll get our conversation going here.
Well, what I try to do in this book is go over every pro-marijuana argument and describe where I disagree with it and why I think it's wrong, and especially looking at the science that shows that it's wrong. But the main, you know, the main reason I'm against this is basically teenage use. That's really the biggest problem.
And why is that?
Well, there's been a lot of research over like the past 10, 15 years. There's all this research about what marijuana does to the teenage brain. Turns out the teenage brain is still developing a lot, and marijuana interferes with that. So teens who smoke pot will have more problems as adults, even if they quit.
So have you seen any of the studies from, for instance, like the Netherlands, where it shows that after they, you know, lowered their, I guess, aggression against cannabis, when they basically legalized cannabis, that the teenage use actually went down?
Yeah, I haven't seen specifics on that, but Netherlands has one of the highest rates of teenage use. There's a UNICEF, in fact, one of the best evidence came out, UNICEF did the study. They looked at almost all the European countries plus the U.S. and Canada. And what they found is the countries with the most lax laws had the highest rates of teenage use, and the countries with the most strict laws had the lowest rates.
That's interesting, because I'm pretty sure I haven't seen that. I've seen sort of the opposite. So this is a problem with having these conversations, is that it's, you know, one study versus another study, whose study is right. You know, to me, we can throw all the studies away. It really is all about ownership of your own body. I mean, what good is threatening teenagers with a jail cell going to do to stop them from using it? I don't know about you, Ed, but when I was a teenager, I used cannabis, and the laws didn't stop me at all.
Right, and I smoked pot as a teenager, too, but I'll tell you, the laws would have stopped me. In fact, when I got caught, it had an effect on me. But it's let me get back to this, though. There are studies that are pretty good. So the UNICEF study is huge, and that's what makes it really good. The National Survey on Drug Use and Health, or the Monitoring the Future. These are really huge studies. And they don't totally paint the picture for us. The UNICEF one really does, but not all of them. But those are pretty good studies. When people take, when people compare just two countries, usually that's a problem because studies don't usually compare two countries. They usually look at a lot of them.
So you mean like a study that might compare the Netherlands to the U.S. and find that teenage use is actually lower in the Netherlands?
Exactly. And it is lower in the Netherlands.
Right. So that's interesting because it indicates that despite the U.S. drug prohibition, where drugs are illegal, or cannabis specifically is illegal, that it has higher use than the Netherlands. I mean, that's pretty interesting, don't you think?
But if you look at the entire study, if you look at all 29 countries, what you find is the top 10 all have very lax laws. And the United States has very lax marijuana laws. We have medical marijuana laws that are basically function like legalization. We have a lot of decriminalization. And so we're fifth or sixth in that study, and then Netherlands is 10th. But if you look at the top countries in that one, Canada, Switzerland, these are countries with decriminalization or no enforcement. In fact, what they are is they're countries that marijuana tourists love to go to because the laws are so lax. Those are all at the top. And then if you look at the bottom, you find all these Scandinavian countries. The Scandinavian countries have decided to really tighten up their laws and be really strict. And they have the lowest rates of teenage use.
So if teenagers are out there using cannabis, and we know they certainly are, are you arguing to recriminalize it, to make it more criminal? What do you want to see out there?
What I want, I don't really want it criminalized, but I want the laws to stay where they are, but not be terribly enforced, which is what we're doing already. People are not going, there's virtually nobody is going to jail or prison just for possession of marijuana. In fact, you don't find those drugs. I work in jails, and I've worked in prisons, and you see people who are in for dealing. You rarely see anybody who's in just for possession, and usually when that happens, something else is going along.
Well, I've actually been in jail, and I was there for civil disobedience. And the first time I was in there, with a guy who was arrested for his third possession charge, and they definitely put him in jail. And this is the claim the police make all the time, is that people in general don't go to jail for cannabis, but they do get arrested for it. And when you get, handcuffs put on you and taken your freedom taken away from you and forced to go into a court system where they then extract hundreds of dollars from you, that's going to lead people to be even more depressed. It could lead them to lose their jobs. And, to me, jail isn't a solution. And it sounds like you might even agree with that.
Yeah, I'm not in favor of putting people in jail. I'm in favor of having the consequence available and almost never using it. Because that seems to be what works best to prevent drug use.
But government doesn't do that, right? Like the government arrests people, they charge them. I mean, I've been in district court. I'm in there a lot just as sort of a hobby. It's a weird hobby, but I'm in there anyway, supporting people going to court and challenging various different nonsense laws. And I see district court arraignments where it's cannabis case after cannabis case. So it's not like these things aren't being enforced out there. At the very least, in states where it's not legal, there are still cops making it, here in New Hampshire, thousands of arrests a year just for simple possession of cannabis. It's a big moneymaker for the state, and it just further impoverishes those people who are the victims of those arrests. I mean, ultimately, isn't this a personal freedom issue, Ed? Isn't this, shouldn't people own their own bodies and be able to make decisions about what to put into them, even if they are a teenage person?
No, we're talking about teenagers, age 12, 13. I see people all the time. And, I treat a lot of heroin addicts. Mm-hmm. And they're 18, 19. We can help them with the heroin. But they tell me they've been smoking pot since they were 12. It is too late to do anything. The only way to help them is to prevent it. And if it's illegal, far fewer people will use it. There's no role modeling. There won't be any advertising. We have 4 million teenagers in this country who are using marijuana regularly.
Ed, would you rather have, as far as advertising, because, it seems like it's going to go to a more legal direction. We've already got 4 states heading that direction. I mean, you're essentially arguing against, the flow of history here, it seems like. Would you rather have teenagers smoking cannabis or smoking bath salts?
that's not the choice. I'd rather have them doing neither. And that's
yeah, but you don't get that because the marketplace filled in. I don't know if you're familiar with the history of the synthetic cannabinoids and the bath salts and such, but what happened there was because cannabis is illegal and MDMA and LSD and other things, they came up with these chemical concoctions made in a laboratory that are designed to ape the chemicals in the illegal drugs, but they're not exactly the same. So therefore, they're different in some ways, and in some ways a lot more dangerous and super scary. And some people have actually died from using bath salts and such. So it's very well likely that people will turn to legal substances, even though they may be more dangerous. Simply because they're available, whereas if cannabis were legal, many of these synthetic drugs may not have ever even hit the marketplace.
Now, that's the substitution theory, and it's pretty much wrong. I see people all the time. People who use one drug are more likely to use another, not less likely. Teenagers don't choose between drugs. They use what's around, and they tend to use what's available and use more than one. What we're hearing from Colorado is people don't smoke pot as opposed to alcohol. They do both.
Well, I mean, there's nothing new there. That's what they were doing before it was made legal. Ed, stand by. We'll come back and continue the discussion here in moments. We've got Ed Gogek. He's a doctor and the author of a book. It's called Marijuana Debunked, and we'll hear more from him here in a moment. He's arguing not to increase the criminal penalties, which I'm glad to hear. I'm glad he's not pushing for the death penalty or something, on cannabis. And we'll come back with that. 855-450-FREE. If you've got a question for Dr. Ed Gogek, this is Free Talk Live. We'll continue with the live Sunday edition here in moments. Again, toll-free number 855-450-FREE.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
Quantitative easing, unemployment at depression levels, Europe financial system falling apart, China getting out of U.S. treasuries. At the end of 2008, the time of TARP, the national debt was at $11 trillion, gold trading around $850 per ounce. Close to 2012, the national debt exceeded $16.4 trillion, gold doubled to $1,600 per ounce. The $20 trillion threshold for the national debt is inevitable. Politicians in Washington have a ferocious appetite for spending and stimulus. What's worse, a printing press to finance. 100 years ago, we had a gold standard to limit this madness, but now you have to adopt your own gold standard. Don't be fooled with paper promises. Get Midas Resources 10 Reasons to Buy Gold free by calling 800-686-2237. Understanding the gold and silver market may be the only insurance you could have to avoiding the next economic crisis. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order your free copy. Again, that's 800-686-2237.
This is The Onion Week in Review. Researchers at the University of Washington report that they have successfully trained 7-year-old chimpanzee Makoko to do all of the tasks necessary to conduct a 3-year study on primates. According to the scientists, Makoko has efficiently learned to turn in thorough analyses of behavior in chimpanzees, fill out all of the necessary paperwork to ensure compliance with the Animal Welfare Act, and even apply for supplemental grant funding from the National Institutes of Health. Sources within your office reported today that the guy on the third floor with two computer screens on his desk is not f***ing around. Co-workers said that the man, currently working with at least 3 programs open on each screen, was absolutely tearing it up, with sources adding that watching the man run a group video chat while dragging 2 separate Google documents to his second screen was like something out of f***ing Minority Report or something.
Jesus, he's just dragging things from one screen to the other like it's nothing. He's going balls to the wall over there. Christ, man, I don't think he's blinked in 3 minutes.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com. When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime. It's awesome to be surrounded by like-minded, freedom-loving activists who've moved here to New Hampshire. From politics to civil disobedience, we have it all. Where I came from, it felt that no matter what I did, liberty was dying. Perhaps you feel the same way? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
Hey, it's Free Talk Live. You're invited to join us. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We're talking about legalization of cannabis, and it's really hard sometimes to find someone who's willing to even call into the show to take the position that things should stay as they are, where things should be, these drugs like cannabis should be illegal. They should remain the status quo, at least in the places where they're illegal. And Ed Gogek is our guest. He's a doctor and the author of Marijuana Debunked, which so far in the conversation, we're going to bring Ed back on here in a moment. He's making a lot of claims about the teenagers and, that they supposedly are going to use drugs more or use cannabis specifically more if it were legal. And of course, it seems like, you can always find studies that contradict one another. Here's a headline from Forbes from last month. Legalized medical marijuana doesn't increase teen usage. A study found. Now, this was an exhaustive study, over 24 years of data from over a million teenagers in 48 states. We're going to bring Ed back on. He can respond, and you can call in too if you've got a question for Ed. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. I want to let you know about ExpressCoin. It's the best choice for getting cryptocurrencies. Bitcoin, Litecoin, or Dogecoin. It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. And they are a licensed money services business. You get your cryptocurrency with money order or check and start off over at ExpressCoin.com, whether in the U.S. or Canada, ExpressCoin.com. They've got a smartphone app, or you can just do it straight through their website. So get started over at ExpressCoin.com, and don't forget to use coupon code FTL, like Free Talk Live, and get up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency with no fee at all. That's no transfer fee on up to $40 worth over at ExpressCoin.com with coupon code FTL. I want to get to your calls and thoughts for Dr. Ed Gogek. He is with us here. Ed, thanks for sticking with us for the conversation. I appreciate it.
Yeah, can I talk about that Forbes article?
Please.
Okay, because I just wrote an op-ed, which I'm having a hard time getting anyone to print, that the headline they had in Forbes is not what the study showed. The study was what's called a negative finding, which means they looked for something and didn't find it. And all it means is, and the way they looked, it was a very exhaustive study, but I've read several of these studies that do that. And the news media has a tendency to misinterpret them, saying that they prove that that medical marijuana doesn't increase teen use, and that's not what it shows. It was actually a bad headline.
Okay. Well, so again, it's like back and forth, study versus study. This was accurate, this wasn't, etc. To me, it really comes down to a moral issue. And Ed, it sounds like you want to continue arresting people, both teenagers and adults, for possession of cannabis. Is that right?
No, I just want to have the laws there. I don't really want to see people arrested.
Well, it doesn't work that way, man. I mean, I wish it did work that way, but unfortunately, as long as the laws are there, the police's attitude is, well, we're just doing our job. I've been to cannabis legalization / decriminalization hearings, and I watched the Police Chiefs Association trot themselves in time and time again, bring out the same old prohibitionist propaganda, and on one hand claim they're just enforcing the law and just doing their job, but on the other hand, they actually argue to stop things like decriminalization and legalization. And there are thousands of people who are being arrested just here in New Hampshire alone, and hundreds of thousands more in all of the other states. I think it's over 500,000 cannabis arrests every single year. This is ruining people's lives. And so I'm glad that you, at the very least, don't want to see those arrests continue. But I'm afraid the only way that's going to stop is with either decriminalization, ending prohibition, or legalization. So I know you don't want to see legalization happen, but what about some decrim? What about making it so it's no longer an arrestable offense?
Let me go on with this. Most of those arrests, in fact, almost all those arrests, are when people are caught with marijuana when they're being arrested or searched for a completely other reason. The police are not actually going out looking for marijuana, or if they are, it's extremely rare.
You'd be surprised, because the police pull people over all the time, and they, you know, will make the claim that they smell marijuana, and they'll search somebody's car, and even though they haven't done anything else wrong, they haven't harmed anybody else, they'll get arrested for it. I mean, look, I've been in the underground for a long time. I know people in the drug culture.
Wait, driving under the influence of marijuana is extremely harmful. It doubles the rate of a...
I didn't tell you that it was necessarily a person who was driving. Sometimes they're passengers who are in the car. And besides that, there are studies that show that cannabis users are safer drivers than non-cannabis user drivers.
There are not. Again, what the marijuana lobby does is they take negative studies. If you look for something and don't find it, it doesn't mean it's not there. Mm-hmm. So there are lots of negative studies. The scientific community has made a huge effort to get people to publish negative findings. It's when they looked for something and didn't find it.
Well, that's not what I'm referring to. I'm referring to, I believe it was an Australian Department of Transportation was one of the original ones from years ago. I mean, I don't have this in front of me right now, but if I'm recalling correctly, it basically found, it was statistically insignificant, but it essentially found that cannabis users were slightly better drivers. It was an actual driving test. Were better drivers than non-cannabis users were. And they also tested alcohol, which, of course, was hugely dangerous for people that were behind the wheel. Let's go to some phone calls here, Dr. Gogek. I want to bring some folks on who might have some comments. First up, we got Sean. He's in California. Sean, you're on with Dr. Ed Gogek. Do we have Sean in California?
Hey there. All right. First, quick comment is that even without getting arrested, here in California, it's, you know, really low priority or whatever, but even just getting a citation can kind of screw up your life a little bit. If you're a student, if you're a teenager, whatever, having that to deal with or that possibly on your record can definitely screw with you. And then the other thing is that I'd like to know how the doctor supports prohibition, which is, you know, enabling the drug war, enabling the you know, putting these Chapo Guzmans in power and these cartels and these, you know, massive drug wars, you know, tens of thousands or hundreds of thousands of deaths in Mexico. I'd like to know his thoughts on that.
Thanks, Sean, for the call. I appreciate it. Go ahead, Ed.
Sure. I'm actually going to be kind of tough on this. There is no reason that people have to smoke marijuana. And so when we look at this, we're talking about a choice between something that doesn't have to be done and problems that it causes. So regarding the cartels, there were no cartels in the 1940s and 1950s when we had very, very tough marijuana laws. The problem is people using the drug. And I'm gonna say it that firmly. And it's also the same thing with teenage use. There simply is no way to have this drug widely available without huge numbers of teenagers using it. And what we know about teens who use it is they do worse in school, they drop out at twice the rate of non-users, they earn less as adults. Brain studies have shown they actually have less gray matter, their IQs are lower. This is a drug that is causing serious problems, and right now we have 4 million teens who are using it. I don't know of another way to prevent it than to keep it illegal.
Yeah, but you're not preventing anything. I mean, that's the thing. I mean, I was a teenager, and I know that, and I know right now that teenagers are using it. And it, I got to say, you know, it didn't affect me personally as far as my success. I've used cannabis throughout my adult and teenage life. And, you know, I've got a relatively successful radio program here as a result of that. And everybody I've known that has been a cannabis user, which to me, Ed, it's actually hard to count the people who I know who don't use cannabis, whether it's occasionally or frequently. It seems like almost everybody does at some level. And, you know, a lot of those guys were teenage users as well. And I just don't see the evidence for it in my life. And studies to me are, you know, are obviously easily manipulable. But you said you were willing to stick with us, right, Ed? Because I'd love to keep you on.
Sure.
More with Ed Gogek. He is the author of Marijuana Debunked. And we're going to continue. If you've got a question for him, call in toll-free on this live Sunday edition of Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. It's Free Talk Live. More coming up.
If you owe $10,000 or more to the IRS or state in back taxes, you know they'll never stop coming after you. With bank levies, wage garnishments, they'll even seize your home or business. The good news? A government program for tax debt forgiveness. It's called the Fresh Start Initiative.
I'm Paul Sibley with U.S. Tax Shield. We can help navigate the new laws, get you protected, and resolve your tax issues permanently.
Call the experts at U.S. Tax Shield now for your free consultation and get a guaranteed quote to resolve your case. Call 800-436-6451. That's 800-436-6451.
Anytime, any place, anywhere. Radio remains the most intimate of all forms of media. At home, at work, in the car, on smartphones. Over 90% of consumers still listen to radio every week. That makes choosing radio as a place to advertise your business one of the best decisions you can make. Email advertise@gcnlive.com and partner up with an experienced GCN representative. Advertise@gcnlive.com. Easy, affordable, effective.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 85% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. If you're a regular reader of FreeKeene.com, you know there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at FreeKeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at FreeKeene.com. That's FreeKeene.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Nesquik. Try Nesquik 4-packs, perfect for lunches and great for kids on the go. Look for it in the juice aisle. Snack time is a great chance to sneak extra calcium into your child's diet without making him feel like he's eating something he doesn't want. Serve up dairy-rich foods like smoothies, flavored milk, frozen yogurt, and string cheese. He'll love the treat, and you'll love knowing how good it is for him. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. Woo! That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Yes, indeed. It is Free Talk Live, the live Sunday edition of the show. Of course, you can dial in toll-free and join us here. You can bring up anything you want, but you'll have to hold off on those anything-you-want calls until we're done with Dr. Ed Gogek. He is with us here until further notice. We were originally scheduled for a half hour with him, but he was gracious enough to allow us to go on because we're talking about an issue that is very near and dear to my heart, which is cannabis. Of course, I want to see it. I want to see prohibition ended on cannabis. But Dr. Gogek, as we've discovered here, isn't as much as a prohibitionist as I thought he was going to be. So I want to give Ed some credit for that. He is saying that on one hand, he doesn't want to see people arrested for cannabis, but on the other hand, he wants to keep the laws in place. And unfortunately, you just can't have it both ways because the police will continue to arrest as long as the laws are in place. Unfortunately, I wish they would stop right now. I keep trying to convince them. You know, I talk to them regularly on the streets here in Keene, New Hampshire, that and inform them that what they're doing by arresting these folks is wrong and it's, you know, moral outrage and it's counterproductive and it doesn't help people, etc. But yet they continue to do it. And I'll be honest, you know, not all of them do. Some of them will look the other way, but not as a whole. As a whole, thousands of people in New Hampshire alone and hundreds of thousands across the United States are being arrested, both teenage and adult, for cannabis. We'll continue the discussion with Dr. Gogek here in moments. I want to welcome Mark into the studio here. Hello, Mark.
Thank you.
Was it a pig emergency or something? I don't even know what happened to
it. My mother is visiting, and she had planned a play, and who thought a play was going to go on for 3.5 hours?
She was in a play?
No, she just
went to go see one.
Yeah.
Cell 411, it's a decentralized micro-social network. You can send alerts to your friends, your family members, your neighborhood watch group, activist group. Cell 411 works, and it works well. If you're pulled over by police, if you need medical help, if your car breaks down, you can send an alert to your trusted group of friends with your exact GPS coordinates. And if they're available to help you, they can hit respond, indicate that they're coming to your aid, and you'll get a notice saying so-and-so's coming. And here's how far away they are. Very handy stuff. Whether, again, you're in a neighborhood watch or whatever, you can send all kinds of notices. If you see your friend being arrested for cannabis, you can send a notice saying somebody's being arrested. There's all kinds of notices you can send out. It's really handy. It's all of 99 cents in the Google Play Store right now. It's Cell 411, C-E-L-L 411, and you can go and download it. iPhone users, stand by. It's in the process of being approved for the iOS Play Store or the App Store as well. So check out Cell 411. As we go back to Ed Gogek, we do have some other people who want to call in, Ed, with questions for you. But thanks for staying with us here. What did you have to say to the guy who pointed out that teenagers, specifically people in college, if they get arrested, even if they don't go to jail, the marijuana conviction can really screw up their experience? I mean, you claim that it's bad for teens to smoke, but it's even worse to get kicked out of college or lose college funding, isn't it?
I put a whole section in my book about, the thing is, the pro-marijuana people present it as if it's either criminalization or legalization. But in the countries that have dealt with this most successfully, there's a third way, which is they use the laws, but not as punishment and not as a long-term problem for people. They use the laws to get a lot of substance abusers into treatment, and then they have forgiveness clauses where that you can completely erase it from your record. And I strongly suggest those. There's all sorts of other ways that you can get around that besides getting rid of the whole law. I call it destigmatization. So, for example, I was once actually turned down for a job because of my marijuana use 40 years earlier. And I don't think people should be asking about drug use more than 10 years ago for any job. There's a lot of ways you can get around that without legalizing the
drug. Did you get arrested for it as a teenager?
No, I got in trouble for it.
What do you mean? How did you get in trouble?
I got in trouble. I was at a youth group function, and I got thrown out of the organization. The whole community was very upset about this. My parents were, everybody.
How did they find out 40 years later about that? Tell them?
That 40 years later.
You what?
When you work in a jail or prison, they interview you about past drug use.
Mm-hmm.
And they decide whether or not you're an okay person to work there. And they even do it with doctors, even though we're working with drug addicts all the time. And I actually got turned down from a job for that once. So I think destigmatization is really important. I do not think that an arrest should be held over somebody. But the way to do that is get rid of the stigma, not get rid of the whole law.
Well, what about ending criminalizing it? What about removing it from misdemeanor status? What about a decrim down to just a violation level, like a lot of states have done?
I used to think that was a good idea, but I've just been looking, and I know you don't like different studies, but the UNICEF study is a huge study of all the countries in Europe, plus the USA and Canada, and the countries that have decriminalized all have much, much higher teenage marijuana use.
Is that,
I'm talking about teenagers ages 11 through 15.
Are we talking about places like Portugal and Amsterdam and those sorts of places?
Definitely Netherlands, much higher rate. Portugal actually, functions like a big drug court. Although they've decriminalized it, they still arrest people. And what they do is they don't threaten you with jail. They send you before a commission, and the commission can impose all sorts of sanctions. It's made up of a psychiatrist, a social worker, and a lawyer. I mean, can you imagine having me there deciding how somebody's going to be punished if they refuse to do treatment? I could be really tough.
I'd rather have a drug treatment counselor than a judge any day.
They're very similar now because they're what's going on in Arizona where I've been is they're starting to hire drug counselors to be probation officers, and the judges are getting training in that. So the two are kind of coming together.
I want to bring Gabriel on the line. He's in New Mexico listening to Kiva in Albuquerque. Go ahead, Gabriel.
Hello.
You're on with Dr. Ed Gogek. Go ahead.
Hey, thank you so much for having me on the air. I just wanted to agree with Eddie. I'm a 5-year firefighter. I got my medical marijuana card. The thing is that, you know, I haven't smoked in about 3 or 4 days. I do have my card, but I believe it's more a medicinal, you know, like at night when I rehash things, it helps me calm down. And I'm sure a lot of people here in New Mexico are feeling the same way.
Ed, what do you think about medical? I don't think we've really covered that yet. Thanks, Gabriel, for the call tonight. Dr. Ed Gogek's with us here, the author of Marijuana Debunked. You've got 25, 27 states, somewhere in that range, with cannabis that is legal for medical use. Are you feeling like that should stay as is, or do you want to end the medical marijuana programs?
Yeah. New Mexico is one of the few states with a really tight, strictly run medical marijuana laws where most of the marijuana actually goes to people with a serious medical illness who are helped by it. In most of the rest of the states, it pretty much functions as a conduit for drug abuse.
Wait a minute. That's not a fair thing to say. Because not everybody who uses cannabis is an abuser, right? I mean, you do know the difference between someone who uses a drug and who abuses a drug, right?
I'll tell you why I can say that. Colorado did a study of this, and they said, most of the people who are using marijuana are just occasional users, but they account for 4% of the marijuana. 87% of the marijuana goes to daily users, and that's abuse. So most of the medical marijuana goes to people.
How do you define marijuana abuse? I mean, I've used a lot of cannabis in my time, and I can't say that it has harmed me as far as my productivity or anything like that in any way, shape, or form. In fact, I know people who've used cannabis, and it makes them more creative, and they use it as part of their job and what it is that they do.
Yeah, the research is really clear that it doesn't make it more creative. And the other thing that's really obvious—
I don't care about the research. I don't know what the research matters when, you know, you have individuals who have their own personal story about what cannabis does for them. Obviously, for a lot of people, it's helpful. Otherwise, they wouldn't use it.
No, that's not true. We're talking about an addictive drug. Ian, I work with people all the time.
Ice cream's addictive, too. Cannabis isn't a physically addictive drug at all.
No, marijuana is definitely addictive. Marijuana is addictive. Alcohol is addictive. I work with people all the time who are always telling me Xanax is the only thing that helps them. OxyContin is the only thing that works. Vyvanse is the only thing that works.
Do you think alcohol should be illegal too? Because I just stepped in on this.
Good question. Can you stick with us, Ed, for one more segment? Mm-hmm. We'll bring you back. Ed Gogek is with us. He's the doctor who wrote Marijuana Debunked. We'll continue. If you want to get your question in, the toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. This is Free Talk Live.
This message is for home intruders, the cowards who break into people's homes to steal their hard-earned property, criminals who shatter lives and rob people of their privacy and security. Listen very carefully. We're the home security experts at LiveWatch, and we're taking you down. Because we're letting everyone try our newest home security system for one full year in their home. To take advantage of this amazing offer, call now 1-800-670-9259.
LiveWatch has been helping protect homes for years, and we've learned the secrets that intruders like you don't want people to know. Criminals, it's time for you to be afraid, because every person who calls will be protected against cowards like you. To the criminals listening, we're taking you down. To those who want to help protect their homes, call the security experts to try the LiveWatch security system. There are no long-term contracts, and if you're not completely satisfied, you can cancel at any time. Try LiveWatch now by calling 1-800-670-9259. That's 1-800-670-9259.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
A congressman recently revealed that legislation totaling 2,900 pages and involving more than $1 trillion was available to members of Congress for less than 48 hours to study and consider. That's over 60 pages of legislation per hour. Do you think anyone read the entire bill? I'm Jim Babka with DownsizeDC.org. Consider a proposal buried in a 3,200-page, $388 billion bill, which would have empowered committee chairmen or their agents to examine Americans' tax returns. When this horrible provision came to light, no one claimed to know how it got into the bill. One congressman questioned said, "I didn't write it, I didn't approve it, I wasn't even consulted." If your attorney represented you this way, he might be disbarred. But this is how Congress represents you every day. That's why DownsizeDC.org has created the Read the Bills Act. You can force Congress to read their bills before they pass them at DownsizeDC.org.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolfe. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
We are back on the live Sunday edition of Free Talk Live. Got time for you if you want to join us here, especially if you've got a question for Dr. Ed Gogek. He is with us here tonight. He's the author of Marijuana Debunked and is sticking with us to continue this conversation. Ed taking the position, as I understand it so far, that he wants to see marijuana remain illegal, but at the same time doesn't want to see people arrested. So I appreciate that. Unfortunately, the system just doesn't work that way. And also opposing the idea of decriminalization. Mark, you threw a pretty tough question at Dr. Ed Gogek, the author of Marijuana Debunked. Can you recap that question? We'll bring him back on to answer it.
Well, he suggested that something close to daily use of marijuana is abuse. And okay, I'll work with that premise. My question would be, that is something like daily use of alcohol or near daily use of alcohol, is that also abuse? And since he's not looking to do away with the laws that we currently have, and he wants to put people in rehab that that use marijuana, I guess, on a near daily basis, does he want to do the same with alcohol users?
You know, I spent most of my career actually dealing with alcohol and alcoholics, so it's not a drug that I want to defend at all. And my response usually on this is that if you're actually debating making alcohol illegal and replacing it with marijuana, then I'll have the debate with you. But I tend to get pulled into questions about alcohol, and it's not a I don't want to be put in the position of defending something. You know, I don't take on every single issue. I'm taking on the marijuana issue because it's pressing on the country right now.
That sounds like a dodge, though, right? Because, I mean, you know, the question is, if alcohol is harmful to people and you want to see less harm to them, your argument is that the fact that marijuana is criminal means people use it less. So why not advocate to recriminalize alcohol?
No, I don't do that because, you know, I've been involved in a few political movements. I remember protesting actually the Vietnam War. I'm old enough to have done that. And I remember people saying to me, well, you know, cars kill more people than Vietnam. Why aren't you against that? And, you know, there are huge problems with cars that were dangerous, but I simply wasn't the issue I was fighting on. It's not a dodge. I'm really here to talk about marijuana. I can't talk about everything.
Well, I don't know how to do this. I'm kind of the opinion alcohol. Look, I'm a near daily user of alcohol. I may even be an abuser of alcohol. I'm not entirely sure, but I'm pretty sure that my life would be worse. My wife's life would be worse, and my child's life would be worse if I was put in jail for consuming something like two glasses of wine a day.
Mm-hmm.
And that. You know, like the alcohol has been shown. I know that there was a study out of Great Britain. You like your studies, so you're probably familiar with this one. That showed that alcohol was about as dangerous as heroin, and nowhere nearly as dangerous. And marijuana was nowhere nearly as dangerous as alcohol.
Yeah, but you can't. You know, you can always say that. But if you look at certain things, if you know, marijuana makes schizophrenia far worse. Are you still there?
Yes. Right here. Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. If schizophrenia runs in your family, which is the worst drug, alcohol or marijuana? And that's why I say no one should be forced to choose. Every drug can be worse under certain situations. So
you want to ignore alcohol while enforcing laws on cannabis. Look, I'm not advocating to make alcohol illegal. I think everybody should be able to choose what to put in their own body.
No, I told you that I spent most of my career dealing with alcoholism. It is not a drug I want to defend at all. But what I find is that if you pull us off into an alcohol fight, you're going to ask me to take stands on something that's not the controversial issue right now.
Well, to me, it is controversial because, you know, people do get hurt. There are a lot of people who actually die from using alcohol. I mean, for all the studies about what you're saying about people using cannabis, we know people die from abusing alcohol. So it's a far more dangerous drug by any metric. And, you know, look, I don't want to see anybody go to jail for any of these things. I just want to make it clear. I'm only asking you because it seems hypocritical. So I guess another important question is, do you use alcohol, Dr. Ed Gogek?
Extremely rarely, but that's, you know, that's part of being 60 years old, I think.
I don't know what that means. I mean, people,
lots of drunk 60-year-olds.
People of all ages use alcohol at various different times. So essentially, you don't want to put yourself in a criminal category, right? That's why you're kind of dodging that issue.
Oh, no, that's not why it is. Listen, if alcohol were invented today, we would ban it immediately. The only reason is because it's been around for long before we started banning drugs that we realized were harmful.
Well, we probably banned marijuana because the Mexicans and the black people used it. I mean, it wasn't invented 90 years ago. It was banned 90 years ago. They found it in Egyptian pyramids.
We went through a period in this country between about 1910 and the 1930s where we banned all sorts of drugs, and marijuana was one of them. It wasn't banned for a particular reason about marijuana. It was banned because they were banning drugs, and marijuana was one of them.
You're not familiar with like the conspiracy theories that surround like Hearst and the hemp paper and of course you know the racist bannings of marijuana. You're not familiar with these.
It was banned when they banned drugs. It was a public health measure. They saw that people were getting addicted to opiates that were sold legally. They saw people having problems with cocaine that was sold legally. Sure. They banned these drugs at the time.
But cannabis at the time, the suggestion is that marijuana was banned, and it was called marijuana, but they wouldn't have banned it if they had known, because cannabis was a regularly used prescription at that time.
I don't know how
you're not familiar with that? Okay.
No.
Let's bring D on the line here.
All kinds
here.
Of things get said on the radio. That's all I know.
We got D here. He's he or she, I'm not sure, is in Southern California. D.
Mama, put them beans back on the kettle.
Huh?
Hello?
You're on the air.
Hey, how's it going?
You are on the radio. All right, goodbye. All right. Let's go on to Drew
radio.
Listening in Massachusetts. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Drew. You're on with Dr. Ed Gogek.
Hi, Dr. Gogek. Yeah, I completely agree with you. Even though I do smoke pot recreational, I'm almost 60 years old, so I do a lot of construction work, and I see it. And these kids, they're really not the brightest lights on the tree. And I even tell them, I said, hey, you're stupid enough without smoking pot. Why are you smoking pot? Oh, it makes me work better. You think it makes you work better, but it doesn't.
So why do you smoke it?
Just like after work or stuff. Not very much.
So are you like a self-hating marijuana user? You want to, you know, put yourself in jail for the benefit of the teenagers?
No, I don't. It's decriminalized here. It's they generally just throw away the pot. But some of these kids, though, I mean, I'm talking, they've been smoking pot since they've been 11 years old.
Mm-hmm.
Doctor's right, they're dropouts, and, you know, they're good kids, but...
So when they were 11 years old, it wasn't decriminalized. It's because it's only been decriminalized for a couple years there.
No.
Right, so the fact that it's illegal hasn't made it go away. And you're hanging around construction workers. It's not like you're going to a college with a bunch of doctoral students, because I bet you'd find out a bunch of them smoke pot too. Isn't that right, Dr. Ed Gogek? I bet you a lot of the people you went to college with were pot smokers, weren't they?
In college, but nowadays, I hardly know anyone who smokes marijuana.
Maybe they don't want to tell you because they know you want it to be illegal.
Well,
just
I
saying.
Don't. I smoked it when I was younger.
Yeah. No, you know, the thing is, most people...
Sorry, go ahead, Ed.
Oh, I was just going to say, most people at any age actually don't smoke marijuana. I know you said everybody does, but marijuana use peaks at age 20. And even at age 20, most people don't use the drug.
Isn't the concern there that young people who are poorly represented inside the government are going, you know, like this is the difficulty is, right? Like older people drink alcohol, younger people smoke marijuana. Let's throw the marijuana users in jail or force them into treatment or whatever the sort of coercion we're advocating for is. But the alcohol users, we're not going to do that. I mean, that's what's painful for me here is that we can't apply consistency. I know you're here to talk about marijuana, but I mean, marijuana exists in the real world, and in the real world, alcohol's legal.
Yeah, but you pro-marijuana guys always bring up alcohol because marijuana can't stand on its own. That's what I think. So I'd be glad to just talk about marijuana. Like I said, if alcohol were invented today, we would never legalize it.
I think you're probably right. There are a lot of officious, stinking government bureaucrats who are two-faced who would absolutely vote to make this stuff illegal. And they'd ride on the backs of the crazy moral majority people who want to jam their version of God down people's throats.
Ed, your book available over at Amazon and the usual suspects? Yeah.
It'll be available at Amazon. Right now, it's just on the website, marijuanadebunk.com, but it's going to be released on August 15th, so then it should be on Amazon.
Well, I want to thank you for even daring to come on Free Talk Live, because most people won't talk about this with us, and I don't want to wish you good luck, because I hope that you fail.
The worst of luck to you, Ed.
Thanks, Ed. You've been very generous with your time, and I appreciate that.
MarijuanaDebunked.com.
Dr. Ed Gogek from Marijuana Debunked. We continue. If you want to talk about cannabis, decriminalization, alcohol, whatever, we're not taking any topic off the table here on Free Talk Live. Whatever you want to discuss goes. It is the live Sunday edition. 855-450-FREEZE the number. This is Free Talk Live. We're coming up.
Hey! Hey guys, I'm Tim Baker.
I'm Daniel Brown.
And I'm Sean Stewart.
And we are the You, Me, and BTC podcast.
Cryptocurrency decrypted.
Us three chumps love to talk too much, and for some reason other people seem to enjoy it.
That's why we started You, Me, and BTC,
which is your Bitcoin and Liberty podcast.
Find our show at youmeandbtc.com every Thursday.
We also post Bitcoin-related reviews, opinion articles, and much more.
Subscribe, like, and follow at youmeandbtc.com.
How fast are Allegra gel caps? It's raking the leaves and loving it fast. How strong are Allegra gel caps?
I'm running with my favorite workout partner, Strong.
Non-drowsy Allegra gel caps give you noticeable relief of your toughest allergy symptoms. It starts working in just 1 hour, two times faster than Claritin's first dose, and stays strong for 24 hours.
It's saying yes to pick up football with the guys, Strong.
Allegra gel caps. Nothing's faster, nothing's stronger. Among OTC oral antihistamines. Use only as directed. Visit Allegra.com.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the free state, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Sunday, August 2nd, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.79 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,095 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $283. Antiwar.com reports NATO announced Friday that it has agreed to an Iraqi military request to launch a new program to help retain the nation's military and to help it reform its entire security sector. Iraq's military, trained by the U.S. and its allies during the occupation, has largely collapsed in the face of fighting with the Islamic State. The NATO training program will be conducted in Turkey and Jordan, according to officials, so there is, at present, no intention to permanently station NATO forces inside Iraq to conduct the training. That's likely to change, of course, as efforts to reform Iraq's security forces can't possibly happen entirely abroad, but NATO is trying to downplay just how big of a commitment they are making right now and will slowly escalate the mission. The timing of the announcement is believed to be related to Turkey's increased military involvement against the Islamic State, and the emergency NATO meeting Tuesday called by Turkey likely played a role in the decision to accept a long-standing request from Iraq. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Bitcoin Not Bombs. Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs offers premium publicity campaigns designed to facilitate an organization's adoption of Bitcoin as a payment system and to fully capitalize on that decision in their fundraising efforts. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com. UPI reports after refusing breakfast, a group of 42 maximum security inmates at Utah State Prison's Uinta facility announced a hunger strike and issued demands to state prison officials. In a press release, the Utah Department of Corrections described the group of inmates as documented gang members. Department spokeswoman Brooke Adams told the Huffington Post the inmates' demands include the release of various gang leaders at a different maximum security unit. She says corrections officials are currently reviewing the list of demands but declined to share further details. Prison officials have offered each participating inmate the option to undergo a health checkup in order to check weights and vital signs. The health of inmates will be monitored regularly by prison staff. Officials said in a statement, the department also has inventoried food items in each participating inmate's cell to document potential nutritional intake. The department will continue to offer the inmates meals as regularly scheduled. For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Reuters reports the Attorney General of Texas has been indicted on securities fraud and other charges over an alleged scheme to mislead investors in a technology company, according to the New York Times and other media outlets on Saturday. The three-count indictment against Ken Paxton will be unsealed in Dallas on Monday when the former longtime state lawmaker is expected to turn himself in to authorities. Reuters could not immediately confirm the reports. The grand jury had been asked to determine whether there is enough evidence to indict Paxton, who came to office this year with a strong Tea Party support on first-degree felony charges. Paxton drew national attention when he said county clerks in Texas who object to gay marriage on religious grounds can refuse to issue marriage licenses to same-sex couples, despite the landmark U.S. Supreme Court ruling in June requiring states to allow same-sex marriage. When he was in the state legislature, Paxton was hired to seek clients by an investment firm called Mowry Capital Management, which is facing allegations from the state Securities Board of defrauding investors. The board found in May 2014 that Paxton was not properly registered as an investment advisor in his work with the firm. It reprimanded him and fined him $1,000. Paxton's name also appears in a federal court document as a major investor in a Dallas area firm in a U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission investigation. Court documents in the federal investigation of the technology firm Servergy do not make any allegations of misconduct by Paxton or draw links to the investigation into the securities fraud in Texas. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
According to a groundbreaking new study published Thursday in the New England Journal of Medicine, psychologists have discovered that the average person, while ostensibly appearing to be normal and mentally sound in their day-to-day lives, immediately becomes a deranged psychotic when alone at home.
We observed hundreds of subjects with successful careers, numerous friends, and loving families. Perfectly normal. But as soon as they were at their homes by themselves, they began presenting behavior consistent with those suffering from dementia, schizophrenia, and various other acute mental illnesses.
Researchers illustrated the study's findings with footage of 29-year-old test subject Brian Temple, who, despite having a steady job and maintaining an ordinary social life, exhibited increasingly erratic and unstable activity from the moment he was alone in his apartment, including dancing in his kitchen to no music whatsoever. Making grotesque faces in the mirror for extended periods of time, and seemingly having conversations with no one in particular.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live.
Yes, it is Free Talk Live. We're launching into the second hour of the program, the live Sunday edition. As we continue here, I'm Ian.
And I'm Mark.
We're going to go to your phone calls and thoughts. For those of you just tuning in, we did have Dr. Ed Gogek on the line with us in the last hour to actually take the position, he was, not us, taking the position that criminalization of cannabis should continue. However, when pressed on the issue of alcohol, considering alcohol is far more dangerous than cannabis, he shucked and jived and dodged and refused to really give a straight answer about that, ultimately admitting that he himself is an occasional alcohol user.
I think he said very occasional. One thing he did say is that if alcohol was invented today, we would make it illegal. And by we, I assume he means
the establishment,
government bureaucrats and politicians, because I'm not going to make it illegal. I'm not interested in making it illegal.
We know on this show.
I'm not advocating for the daily use of alcohol or even the occasional use of alcohol, but it's certainly used medicinally. It has a long history of medicinal use, and as is marijuana. And when it comes to recreational drugs, it just seems like people like them.
Sure they do. They like to alter their state of consciousness, and even the good doctor admits that he himself participates in that. So really, it's just that some people believe certain altered states are better than other altered states, and some altered states should apparently be punished with a jail cell or, in his case, forced treatment. So you can comment on any of that if you'd like.
In his defense, right, like he said, look, I don't think a marijuana can stand on its own. Everybody has to kind of go to this alcohol argument. But when he said that we would make it illegal if it was invented today, he basically said that he would like to see alcohol made illegal too. He's a prohibitionist in the sense that he doesn't want people to alter their states. His claim is,
even though he himself has done so.
Yeah, I'm sure he has. And you know, people can make mistakes. There's no problem about it. But the claim that he had was that people aren't sort of more creative because of their drug use. And
he claims there's a study.
Well, he probably knows more studies than we do.
Oh, sure.
But he doesn't claim that people are better off with criminal records. And he certainly wouldn't go so far as to claim that, you know, the establishment as it is today is good at, you know, preventing people from using recreational drugs. He's not going to claim that, you know, that a criminal record's good for people. He's not going to claim that cops are good at, you know, like, he wants to change things just like I do. He just wants to change them differently. He wants the government to work properly. And in Europe, it does. And this is, you know, a pretty common leftist thing to say. It works better in Europe.
Let's go to your phone calls and thoughts. We've got Ahmed, I think. I don't know if I can quite. Arned on the West Coast.
Just take the call and we'll find out.
Hello? You're on Free Talk Live. And now you've dropped off the phone.
He feels bad because you mispronounced his name.
I apologize about that. Russ, I got that one. Russ in New Mexico, listening to Kiva. You're on the air. Russ?
Hello?
You're on the radio. Go ahead.
I was just wondering that. The doctor's comments on prohibition in the 20s and what we did afterwards, as far as alcohol was concerned, after prohibition left, pretty much left a Scarface, what's his nuts, out of Chicago, bankrupt.
Yeah, the gangsters aren't able to make a bunch of money when the products that they're slinging are no longer prohibited.
Right, if marijuana can't stand on its own, imprisoning people for marijuana can't stand on its own either.
Exactly. So what's happening with the so-called war on drugs? The Reagan administration launched that one. I believe it was Nancy Reagan in 1981, 1982, somewhere around there.
The war on drugs has been going on longer than that. It was actually Richard Nixon who really kicked it into gear. It was Nancy Reagan who came up with the Just Say No tagline.
Yes, but how many billions of dollars have our taxpayer money has gone into the so-called war on drugs?
Yeah, great point.
And, you know, nothing really has happened.
Well, the police have gotten more empowered. The police have gotten more weapons and more tanks.
Right,
and
to take away more of our freedom.
Right.
You're absolutely right.
Well, proponents of big government don't care how big the government gets.
Right.
No penny, no $1 million is too much if we can just save one child from one marijuana cigarette one time.
You know, I mean,
like,
it almost sounds
ultimately
like
how it, where it goes.
I mean, you've got to be high to believe that you can have cannabis be criminalized and not have the police enforce the law. I mean, he wants the police to not arrest people when it's illegal to have cannabis. It's just not going to happen that way. I mean, anybody that knows anything about police go ahead.
But these are victimless crimes that are going on in the United States, and these victimless crimes, let's say I sell you a marijuana joint, and I go to prison for 10 years, whereas somebody can take a life and go to prison, and they get a 10-year sentence, and they're out in 3 years.
Absolutely.
I'd like to find anybody who takes a life, maybe driving, drunk driving or something, they might take a life and go for 10 years.
Well, still, I mean, people.
Still, it's still a manslaughter charge, and they're getting out.
Drug charges absolutely are punished way harder per capita than any of the than any of the actual violent crime charges.
Absolutely, but there is always a supply and a demand, and if there is no victim out there, I'm not a drug pusher by any means, but if I was, and I sold you a marijuana joint.
Russ, you don't have to convince me, man. I'm totally on board. I thank you for your call tonight. We agree. Our toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. But the thing is, Dr. Ed Gogek here that we had on in hour number one, the sneaky thing that he's doing is he's just saying, well, yeah, sure, you know, marijuana may not be that bad for adults or whatever, but it's all about the teenagers. Mark, you weren't here for this part of the conversation.
I really did wonder. I missed the first half of it.
It was the very beginning. When I asked him to kind of summarize, you know, the book and his point or whatever, he was saying that, you know, it really is about the teenagers for him and that he wants to protect the children, and that's why everybody should keep getting in his mind, processed by the system for possession.
Did you address with him that half that the teenagers find in the United States find it more easy to find marijuana than they do alcohol?
I did not bring that point up.
Because that's a real issue. That marijuana is more illegal than alcohol is for teenagers. Because, but teenagers, I could get marijuana back in 1980, whatever, late 80s. Mm-hmm. I was getting marijuana more easily than alcohol. I didn't want it. I wanted alcohol. And, you know, we got that too. That was back in the day when you could, you know, hang outside
the grocery store,
and get somebody to buy it for you.
Or the convenience store. I remember that stuff. So share your thoughts here, your experiences. You're welcome to join us. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. I mean, people like Dr. Ed Gogek, and, you know, I am glad that he came on to talk to us. I didn't really know if that was really going to happen. When you proposed it to me, Mark, I was really surprised. We were actually being pitched on an interview for somebody who's a prohibitionist.
No, and, by the way, we gave him ample opportunity to pitch his book, right? Like, that's how Free Talk Live goes. If you come on for a fair...
Well, I pitched
I don't want to call
book.
A fight.
You're I right. pitched his book.
Well, we did.
Yeah. I mentioned it multiple times throughout. I mean, if you want to go read some marijuana prohibitionist claptrap, well, there you go.
I'm sure he's got studies, man.
That's the problem is everybody, and I pointed this out like within the first segment or so of the interview, was like, well, he had a study that said such and such, and I have a study that says the opposite. And, you know, Ian, your study, they interpreted it wrong, or the article was misinterpreting the study. And it's just all this nitpicking about which study is the right study, and it's really like a penis measuring contest almost. Like, I have the most studies over here, and, you know, I've got the real life experience of seeing people's lives ruined by this insane war on drugs. And
but you're not advocating for teenagers to smoke pot, are you?
I'm not advocating that that they should be put in jail for it. I mean,
right.
I know
well,
they're going to
the
smoke pot.
That's the difficulty here, right?
I know they're going to smoke pot. I'm advocating for harm reduction. And obviously, we didn't get a chance to keep them on longer, but what about some of the consequences of prohibition? Like, oh, I don't know. How about moldy weed? I'm not saying weed won't go moldy if there's no prohibition, but a lot of weed will sit on shelves and, you know, pallets for a period of time, and until it finally hits the streets, and then, you know, maybe by the time it gets to the person who's the buyer, it's got some mold growing in it, which when you smoke mold, there's all kinds of variants on mold out there. Some of that stuff could be deadly, or at the very least mess you up.
Harmful.
855-450-FREE. If it's legal, that's less likely
to
happen.
I'm Steve Sitkowski, a former Wall Street insider. I'm holding a book that will show you investing strategies which could help you earn the kind of money you've always dreamed about. And right now, I'm giving this book away for free. So who needs to read it? If you're in the middle of your career and worry you'll never have enough money to retire, you need to read this book. If you're already retired and your income isn't enough, you need to read this book. And if you don't want to be selling burgers at 80, you need to read this free book. It includes the strategy I use to make a 72% profit on a trade where the stock only moved 12%. You'll need at least $1 million to ever fully retire. If you're behind on that goal, you really need to read Trade Like the Pros. And you can for free by calling 1-800-944-5836. Skeptical that it will deliver results? It's a free book, so what do you have to lose? Find out how at 1-800-944-5836. 1-800-944-5836.
On the average, Americans work between 45 to 50 years, hoping to build up enough wealth to retire and live out their golden years. Unfortunately, with taxation, the rising cost of food, energy, housing, and medical, many retirees are forced to live below the poverty line. Is this a flaw free enterprise, or is our monetary unit we call the Federal Reserve note forcing us into perpetual debt, ensuring inflation and higher taxes? These questions and more can be answered by reading G. Edward Griffin's book, The Creature from Jekyll Island. Congressman Ron Paul states it's what every American needs to know about central bank power. A gripping adventure into the secret world of international banking cartel. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. I will give a silver dollar from the early 1900s to anyone who purchases this book. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order a copy today. It's critical that the public be made aware of the system. Call and order your copy today at 1-800-686-2237. That's 1-800-686-2237.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here. And I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free, at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
In every age, a technology is created that upends the foundations of society. The wheel, the printing press, the internet. Now, in a world sliding into financial chaos, a new technology is changing the way monetary systems work around the world. It is called Bitcoin. Bitcoin is a new form of money controlled not by banks, governments, or corporations, but through mutual commerce between free individuals. To learn more, visit weusecoins.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
Hey, it's Free Talk Live. Welcome to the live Sunday edition. Our toll-free number, it's 855-450-FREE. We're talking about the war on drugs, specifically the war on cannabis, which is the majority of the war on drugs. It's where most of the money is spent enforcing. It's where most of the police man hours are spent. It's the majority of the confiscated product, et cetera, et cetera. And it's ridiculously counterproductive. We're going to continue with your phone calls and thoughts. I do want to let you know about purse.freetalklive.com. I've been out at the county fair last 5 days pitching Bitcoin to people, and it was a great experience. We can talk more about that here in a little bit. But, you know,
I've been telling everybody that you were the bearded woman.
The toughest part, I've actually shaved, Mark, for this, so that would be inaccurate. The toughest part of the purse pitch is trying, you know, it's unbelievable. If you tell somebody, hey, you passersby, how would you like to get 20% off on Amazon? Nobody believes that.
It sounds like a crazy pitch. Like, you sound like a pitch man.
Right.
Well, come over here and see my walk.
But it's true. You really can get 20% off or more on Amazon, or less. You can get less if you, for some reason,
feel free
want
to
less.
Get less.
That's up to you. Purse lets you choose the discount that you receive at Amazon. And you've got it. The catch is, there is a catch. The catch is you have to spend Bitcoin to get the discount. So if you got Bitcoin, then you can get 20% or more off on pretty much anything on Amazon. Go and get started at purse.freetalklive.com. If you've been thinking about getting Bitcoin, this is a killer app. This is a great excuse to get it, because if you do any online shopping at all, this is a no-brainer. As long as you're willing to be a little patient, you can get whatever you want. The order usually gets filled. If it's a 20% discount, you're going to get your order filled probably within 24 hours, if not 2 hours, on Purse.
That's your experience.
Yeah, it's awesome. Purse.freetalklive.com. When you sign up through that link, Free Talk Live gets a very small portion of your purchase price. Go to purse.freetalklive.com to get started. Let's go to Carl in New Jersey, listening to WOBM. Hey, Carl.
How you doing, guys?
Welcome, sir. Go ahead.
I just wanted to give you a little personal story.
Please.
Concerning what Ed was talking about. My son, years ago, was a happy young fellow. I was working out of state or a different part of the state. So what happened, my wife was raising him essentially alone because I worked nights and I'm traveling back and forth. I wasn't around enough to see what was going on. He was a great kid up until he got into high school. Started with a little pot with his friends that we found out later. I thought we actually stopped his car when he was driving around with some friends. And they were smoking, and we didn't like the idea that he was smoking, and we found out later they were smoking pot in the car. Okay, well, this progressed and progressed over a number of years to the point where he was going to parties, and eventually he ran into a nice fellow named Sean, who introduced him to heroin. From the heroin, he developed, of course, the addiction. Have to travel down to Philadelphia to buy this stuff illegally, got tickets coming back from Philadelphia. Well, we thought he had stopped. We went into a program called Beatitudes, which they were trying to help young addicts in the area. Toms River, New Jersey is terrible for the heroin trade and stuff was going on. Okay, we went there for 2.5 years. He went through the whole program. There was a lot of other people there that they were helping. Unfortunately, when the director there had him go away for the rehab, 30-day rehab, he went there. He did fine. He had a friend that was there. The friend got out. The friend died a few weeks later, being on the streets of Philadelphia, and he restarted the heroin. Okay, well, it's a long story, but the thing is, over a period of time, he tried to get off the heroin, and as I say, he went to, on his own, we didn't know about it. He was working at night, and he was making his own living, and he was going to an addiction program where they were giving him the methadone. And he did that for a number of years. We didn't know it until my wife finally found some slips from the methadone clinic, you know, because they give you these little slips when you go to get the treatments every day or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. He did this for a number of years. And finally, we found out he was doing it. We called the director of the program again. He couldn't do anything. We went to a doctor that treated people with the Suboxone, the drug that's supposed to wean people off the heroin.
Mm.
Went there for a big thing, $75 a visit, and he was doing that for almost a year. And he said he was just about done, and we were getting off the Suboxone. And it's about a week after he got off the Suboxone, my wife and I were going shopping. He was on the porch waving to us, "You're gonna pick something up for me at the store." We came home, and he was dead.
Oh. I'm sorry to hear about
that. But they found they did two autopsies, and they found that he had nothing in his system. But over a period of time, his system was so weakened by all the drugs and everything they had taken, he developed an embolism that went to his lung and his heart, and he died almost instantaneously. He was in the room with his dog. We got home, and 3 hours later, and he was just laying across the bed, tried to revive him.
It's a tragic story, and I'm sorry that happened to you, but I don't think marijuana had anything to do with it. I mean, you can talk to other heroin users, and you'll find that they all probably drank alcohol too. So what?
Yeah, well, he never drank alcohol. It just started with the.
How do you know he never drank alcohol?
Well, hold on.
I know. We know his background. He actually had an allergy to he wouldn't take a drink. Like we if he had a drink at a party, he didn't have any drinks. So that wasn't a problem.
I guarantee you, though, every other heroin addict, you'll talk to them, they probably all drank alcohol. It doesn't mean anything.
Well, here's an important question.
Right.
If marijuana wasn't illegal, if he got onto marijuana and it wasn't illegal, right, like alcohol, for instance, do you think that he would have been introduced to the drug dealer who introduced him to heroin? Don't you think it's the illegality of marijuana that really introduced him to this world of illegal drugs?
Well, the way it seemed, it was a sort of almost like an innocent thing. He was just going from the marijuana to the party, and to the party this kid just happened to say, "Oh, try this. It's different." And then after that, boom, he was gone. He was driving to Philadelphia, and picking up this stuff in the streets of Philadelphia. Lucky he didn't get killed in Philadelphia. Just picking up this stuff.
No doubt.
So as I say, where would the initiation come from if it wasn't from the marijuana?
Well, where would the initiation come from if it wasn't for the fact that marijuana was illegal?
Well, what I think Mark is trying to say here is that the gateway drug claim is actually been debunked
the gateway drug claim is true, but it's because marijuana is illegal.
Well, no, Mark. The gateway drug claim, the classic claim, is that marijuana just by its nature makes people want to go and get harder drugs. That's false. The government's own Institute of Medicine study proved it in the late portion of the 20th century. Carl, thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate it. What they did find is what you're talking about, Mark, is that if there is a gateway effect, it's that the underground, the drug marketplace, when you go into the black market to get marijuana, you're introduced in a lot of cases to drug dealers who are loaded with other product and interested in getting their customers hooked on it. More coming up. Free Talk Live.
Did you know some countries are now banning GMO foods? It's true. That's why for quality storable foods, you need ready-made resources. For over 19 years, we've become the name you can trust for thousands of products, like Numana Healthy Food Storage. All Numana storable foods are non-GMO, non-soy, and gluten-free available. Call 800-627-3809 or click readymaderesources.com. Ready-made Resources. We don't just sell the products, we live it.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
This is your Roberts & Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Friday, gold is up $10 at $1,099 per ounce. Silver is 28 cents higher at $14.95 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $284. Roberts & Roberts also makes it easy to sell your gold and silver. To find out more, give me a call at 800-874-9760 or visit our online store at rrbi.co.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
The easiest thing in the world for a reader to do is to stop reading. According to the late, great Barney Kilgore, who became managing editor of the Wall Street Journal in 1941 and grew the paper's circulation from 33,000 to 1 million by the 60s. And he'd be pleased to know that his paper is one of the few that people now pay to read online. Someone else pre-internet who realized that attention is fragile? Motown Records founder Berry Gordy. In the early 60s, when his label dominated the charts, he'd bring a dozen real people into the Hitsville, USA studios and audition songs. And he'd ask, if you were down to your last dollar, would you spend it on this record or would you buy a sandwich? Today, attention span seems like an oxymoron. For tips on cutting through the clutter, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
And we are back with more Free Talk Live on the live Sunday edition of the program. Lots of folks want to get on the line, talk about whatever's on their mind, the war on drugs, the primary topic at the moment. And then on the way here tonight, maybe we'll talk about some of these things libertarians don't understand. Mark, you've got a story from Raw Story about that.
Yeah.
That sounds fascinating. So maybe we'll touch on some of those. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We've also got Skype, where we've actually had a bunch of calls on Skype. Username tonight is lrn.fm, and we're going to go to your phone calls first, where Ed is on the line, waiting patiently in Nevada, listening to KKFT. Hello, Ed. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark.
Yes. Hi, Mark. How are you doing?
All's well. What's on your mind?
Thank you. I don't necessarily agree with the issue of marijuana being a valuable drug, nor alcohol. I get mandatory clients, because I'm a therapist, from their workplaces for coming up positive while the job is showing up under the influence. And a lot of these folks typically started with marijuana or alcohol as a teenager and missed out on a lot of their developmental growth and have serious problems in decision-making, mood swings, mood problems, self and money management, I guess.
Well, of course, well, you're going to have people with issues and problems. They're coming to therapy. I mean, there are also millions of successful
they're being mandated because of they're being mandated because of their drug use.
Well, it's interesting that the therapist thinks that they have problems. What my experience is in when I was in high school is a lot of high school. Most of my fellows in high school, they used marijuana. And now, you know, I go back to the reunion. It's 25 years later. People's lives seem reasonably good. I mean, I don't see these things that you're talking about. I'm not claiming marijuana is good for young people. And usually people run to young people here. Anybody who advocates for marijuana being legalized advocates for an age of consent.
Right. And the people that I see are working. They're at the age of consent. And it is their employers who are requiring them to seek treatment before possibly firing them from coming to work under the influence of either alcohol or drugs.
So do you advocate for the legalization of alcohol, too?
Sure.
Because that would be that would be consistent.
Yeah. You really want to go back to alcohol prohibition?
I mean, they made it legal for a reason.
Haven't you studied history?
First of all, I realize that that's impossible right now, considering how society works.
But what
that
about
would be unrealistic.
The reasons that they made alcohol legal again, right? Like the Valentine's Day massacre,
money.
The increase in crime,
money.
The incarceration rate.
Money.
Yes, it's absolutely money. Money for stinking counselors. I mean, like that's what we currently have
money
with the prohibition.
Money for stinking counselors, money for stinking jails, money for the emergency room for the people who are drug overdosed or alcohol overdose.
Yep.
Money.
It's money, right?
Ed, thanks for your call tonight. I appreciate
it. It costs a lot less if we just made it legal.
Appreciate your call, Ed. Wow, what a surprise. The people who are acting out at work have issues, whatever they are. Now, maybe they're treating their mental issues with drugs, and that's not working very well. Of course, a lot of psychiatrists will go ahead and prescribe other drugs to them, and they are, there's a lot of arguments that those other drugs might even make things worse. Oh, what about all those school shooters that we hear about so often? Seems like almost every single one of those people is on some sort of prescription narcotic substance, usually being prescribed by some sort of shrink. So I'm not convinced that that's the solve to the problem, but why should anybody be surprised when people who are having issues at work turn out to have personal problems and issues with addiction and things like that? But what about the millions of Americans who are productive members of society who use cannabis or use alcohol on a regular or irregular basis? You don't hear the stories about them because they're successful.
I don't want to live in the America where alcohol and caffeine and tobacco are all outlawed, because I mean, you know, you're going to be looking around the corner. Everybody's going to be going to jail. It's crazy.
I bet you can find a lot.
You know who'd be well employed? Drug treatment counselors.
I bet you can find a lot of heroin users who also had some caffeine before in their life too, before they started heroin. I mean, the idea that there's also motorcycle riders who drove a car first. Also, everyone who's ever died in a motorcycle accident drank milk at some point in their lives. I mean, it's just, you can make some ridiculous connections.
I think that, you know, what's fair when one makes the gateway argument is that marijuana is illegal, and that introduces people to it introduced you, Ian. You were, you know, upon using marijuana, you realized you'd been lied to a great deal.
Yeah, that's right.
In your schooling. And this is what happens. When you make these things illegal, people who get a hold of them are like, suddenly, whoa, this isn't so bad. This is great. This is awesome. And they feel lied to by the people they trusted. And that's a terrible thing.
Miles is on the line on Skype, actually, via California. Mike, Miles, go ahead with your thoughts.
Hey guys, how you doing?
Welcome,
I just
sir.
Am a little bit irritated by this whole drug legalization arguments going on. It's a dead issue. We've already seen what happens when you take the government out of the drug regulation business. Deaths go down, use goes down, it seems like it's kind of a red herring to me. Like, everyone, you know, when you tell someone you're a libertarian, the first thing they think of is drug use. Mm. And it's like, I don't even do drugs. I don't, you know, I'm kind of, I'd rather not be the generation that's known as, oh, we legalized cannabis. Like, that seems really,
don't worry. It's not your generation getting it done.
What's that?
Don't worry. It's not your generation getting a ton. I can assure you, the millennials are not the ones who are finally getting weed legalized.
Well, do you know what I'm saying, though? It's like,
I get it. You don't want to be painted with that.
And anyone who's done any research into the topic knows. I mean, the guy that was calling in a minute ago talking about gateway drugs, like, that's it's not an argument. There's no logic behind that.
Well, that guy, his son died, and I can imagine. Logic's out the window when something like that happens.
Not necessarily. There was an article I had in show prep a little while back about a lady in the UK who, after her 15-year-old daughter died on an overdose of what was alleged to be MDMA, but I don't know if it actually was, but some sort of party drug. She actually came out and spoke in favor of legalization because she saw that her daughter might still be alive had it not been for the fact that these drugs were illegal and so therefore could be debased with some other product and essentially, you know, would have been less likely to poison her her daughter had they been actually legal. You could more measure your doses if they're legal, etc. But yeah, you're right, Mark. Most people don't really see things clearly. When they, you know, they're clouded by the anger of what has happened to their loved one.
But I mean, he's not seeing how many people, how many lives are ruined by the war on drugs.
Yep.
Countless more than even if cannabis did kill people by smoking it. Like, there's absolutely no comparison at all.
Miles, so, I think you nailed it. Anything else you want to share? Go ahead.
It's just irritating. Why are we still talking about this? You know what I mean? But anyways, I love your guys' show. Please keep up the good work.
Thanks, brother. Thanks for the call tonight. Appreciate it. Miles called on Skype. You can do that too. Skype.
Sounds great, didn't he?
Yeah, he did. The Skype username is lrn.fm. We're going to continue here. We've got Veach. We got Veach on the line in Reno on Skype as well. Go ahead, Veach.
Hi, gentlemen. Thanks for taking my call. Sure. I want to send out my condolences to that gentleman that called in. It's got to be really hard to lose a loved one, let alone your son. So I would make the argument that there's no such thing as bad drugs, just bad users.
I want to hear more about that. Stand by, Veach. Sure. We'll bring you back. 855-450-FREE is our toll-free number. Skype username's lrn.fm. Coming up, the war on chalk escalates at the county fair. It's Free Talk Live. We'll tell you what happened at the outreach booth this week.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
We the people grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson, Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Free Talk Live.
But we have the opportunity. No one has the opportunity.
Look, just hold on. Just because the slaves can pick the head slave doesn't mean that the slaves are free.
Oh, that's ridiculous. That's ridiculous. Look, if people actually got up and voted for things, there might actually be some change.
People do actually get up and vote for things, and a change always results in the same crap.
What are you going to do that's different by voting?
Two choices between crap sandwiches, man.
You're speaking out of both sides of your mouth. On the one hand, you're saying, oh, hardly anybody votes, so I can't, you can barely say this is a person of right. And then I said, well, gosh, if people get up and vote, maybe things will change.
Hold on, that was only one thing he brought up.
Here's what I mean.
When people do vote, it doesn't make any difference because of a number of reasons.
People never vote in numbers that could actually reflect what.
Why should I vote for any of these thugs? They're killers. They're murderers.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at lrn.fm.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up.
Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
Yeah! Hey, it's Free Talk Live. Of course, you can dial toll free to join us here at 855-450-FREE. We've also got Skype. The Skype username is lrn.fm. And with you tonight, it's Ian.
And Mark.
Bitcoinist.net is the ultimate resource for Bitcoin industry news, reviews, education, and the latest in the cryptocurrency ecosystem. Bitcoinist is the prime online destination for information about the Bitcoin and digital currency industry. Their website integrates a community forum breaking Bitcoin and digital currency news. And they also aim to cover fintech and blockchain tech news as well. Bitcoinist has very sophisticated Bitcoin network statistics, a solid beginner's guide to Bitcoin, and more. The Bitcoinist platform serves the needs of everyone looking to keep up with Bitcoin and digital currencies, from beginners to experts. Go to Bitcoinist.net and check it out. That's Bitcoinist.net. Ian and Mark continuing here as we go back to Veach, who's with us in Reno via Skype. You barely had a chance to get your thoughts out in the last segment, so go ahead, Veach. What were you calling about tonight?
No problem, gentlemen. Well, I submitted that there's no such thing as bad drugs, just bad users. And when you look at the resources that are available now with the internet, it's like you can talk to people, go on forums. People aren't going into this blind anymore. So to jump into a drug like heroin when there's so much information about there in terms of its addictive properties and its potential fatal nature, it's silly to me for people to even get caught up in these things now, lifestyles or whatnot. I can see it happening, but there's a lot of resources available. So I would make the argument that if you take heroin once, with all the information that's out there, you're a bad user. Same with what they created in Russia, because they got so good at clearing out heroin, crocodile came up as a substitute.
Yeah, crocodile.
Your skin falls off your body. You watch yourself rot, and you still elect to take that. Well, that's the physical chemical addiction coming into place. But knowing all of that that's out there and you still elect to take this, you're a bad user.
Yeah, I see where you're coming from. And that sort of ties in with the study that we talked about a little while back, where they took crack addicts and meth addicts, put them in a hospital environment for a study where they were offered the most pure form of crack and meth they
the
could
good
possibly
crack.
Have. Yeah, like the best they could possibly get. And they were given that on a daily basis, or they could choose. They could choose the best possible hit of crack rock or meth, or they could select a $20 reward at the end of the 3-week study. So they would be staying in that hospital for the 3 weeks. So they weren't getting the cash right away. They weren't getting an instant gratification on the cash. And what they found out was that even these what were supposedly hopeless drug addicts were willing to forego the drug that they were supposedly super addicted to in order to cash in at the end of the 3 weeks. And so it showed that
it wasn't a huge amount of money, $20, right?
Per day, $20 per day.
Yeah, not much.
Well, it's probably, you know, at the end of 3 weeks, that's probably more money they had in their pocket at one time than
agreed,
in recent
but it
memory.
Just, I mean, you're not talking about, you know, folks that are saying, okay, well, I'll just take that, because for $20, that's a hit of crack.
They also tried it for $5, and then they were less likely to take the $5. So they were more likely to take the crack rock rather than the $5. So, but what the study showed was that this is not necessarily about pure addiction. It's more about incentives and more about these people having no hope and nothing to live for, and so they're trying to lose themselves in these drugs. And so again, that would be more about a bad user, somebody who's just in a bad place in life and making poor choices rather than the drug itself.
Wow, that's insane. Wow.
It was a great
study.
Let
me close. Let me close with this. To borrow from Timothy Leary, set and setting, and you can apply this to, you know, a bar, you know, like if you're in a bad mood, maybe you shouldn't go out and consume alcohol. It's only going to, you know, mess things up in between your own ears. So always apply set and setting and know your dealer. So
good
thank
advice.
You very much, gentlemen.
Thanks, Veach. Appreciate it. And by set and setting, what he's talking about is certainly with psychedelics, and it's probably true to some extent with other drugs, but with, you know, psychedelic drugs, having a calm place to be, being around good people, people who you love and, you know, that care about you, your friends, being around in the right set and setting is super important to have a drug journey go as positively as possible. So again, it is about being a bad user versus a good one. Are you making responsible decisions with the drugs that you're using? I understand there are some people listening who think that the use of drugs, period, is irresponsible. And I'm sorry, that's a crock. There's you know, no evidence for that. There's plenty of evidence to show that there are responsible people who use drugs responsibly. And you know how you know that? Well, you really don't know it because they're responsible about it and they don't put it in your face and they do it on the weekends or they do it at night and they do it without you ever finding out about it. It's likely many of your friends and family members, if you're one of these prohibitionist types, you probably have people who are close to you who are responsible drug users and you don't know it. And you don't know it precisely because they're the responsible types. They still hold a job. They're doing very well. They're able to take care of their kids. They're able to meet their responsibilities and pay their bills. So you would never necessarily think, oh, my brother or my sister or dad or whoever is a regular drug user. But just because you're a user, as I pointed out with the doctor who was on earlier, doesn't mean you are an abuser. Abuse is when you cross the line between use of a responsible sort into irresponsible use, to where the use of the drug becomes a problem. It becomes something that creates an issue at work. It becomes a problem that creates an issue at home.
Health issues,
etc. So 855-450-FREE is our number. Let's continue. We'll go first to Keith. He's in Des Moines. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Keith.
Hello. Well, I'd have to say irresponsible use is when you're smoking so much pot that you develop extreme depression and a mild case of paranoia. I mean, it took me 5 years to get all the little voices in my head back in line. So that's my personal take on it.
Yeah, I know that marijuana can definitely it's strongly associated with some, usually males, young males that you know, for whatever reason, it's associated with psychosis in young males. But that doesn't mean
I was a day-to-day user self-medicating for pain.
Yeah.
But as far as the laws go, my biggest problem with the law is that they made it so all-encompassing that you can't grow industrial-grade hemp in your own backyard anymore because of the way they wrote the laws. But then too, you have the real problem that comes in where you have the other problem that comes in with the actual legalization of it is it tends to, you know, it tends to work off the bottom of the food chain, and it takes a lot of people out of action who might actually, if they learned how to carry on a decent job, you know, they would be more inclined to be more productive.
What evidence do we have that people are taken out of action? Which, I mean, I just don't know.
Take my daughter for example.
Okay.
And she's 20 years old. And unfortunately, we just kicked her out of the basement. So
there's a lot of 20-year-olds living in a lot of basements in America right now. And I mean, the minimum wage could be just as much of a problem for your daughter as anything else. Has she ever had a job?
Not really, because if the minimum wage goes up, it just means the cost of everything else goes up around it. You know, basic economics 101.
It doesn't. That's not basic economics 101, because what happens in a retraction?
I learned about that in seventh grade.
Okay, well, all right. Listen to this. You're older now. Maybe you can hear something new. When a labor market contracts and you have a minimum wage in place, what that will do is it will push out of that marketplace younger people, because when a market contracts, demand goes down, and therefore prices go down. Price for labor, since it is unable to go below the minimum, then people will then young people will be pushed out of the marketplace, because that's the people who are supposed to be getting the minimum wages, young people, and maybe people who don't have a command of the English language. And so then you'll have people who are in their 25 or 30-year-olds pushing those people out of those jobs.
Yeah, but he's right though, Mark, that a lot of times prices go up when the minimum wage goes up.
Yeah, but that takes time. It puts upward pressure on pricing, but that doesn't do anything for the young people who are out of work. All you have to do is look at the statistics, and you will see that this isn't so much a recession. This wasn't a recession so much on regular workers. It was a recession on young workers, and even more so on ethnic workers.
Well, either way, if you smelled my daughter's bedroom, believe me, we wouldn't even be having that conversation.
Oh, I don't disagree that she's probably smoking pot.
Thanks, Keith. Appreciate hearing from you. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Hey, guess what? There are losers who like to smoke pot, and there are also winners who like to smoke pot. We'll come back with more here in moments. It's not the pot that turns someone into a loser. I don't believe that for a moment. Hour number three is on the way. Free Talk Live.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit strategicshelters.com.
This is Shaquille O'Neal.
And the Shaquettes.
Reminding you that anytime is a good time.
Good time.
For the cooling, drying, fresh scent of Gold Bond Powder Spray. Like after the gym.
Or a crowded elevator ride.
Or golf.
Or working with farm animals.
Or a hard day's work.
Like sports casting?
You said it, ladies. Stay cool with Gold Bond Powder Spray.
Stay cool with Gold Bond.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at Facebook.FreeTalkLive.com and then hover over it to click Get Notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.FreeTalkLive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Sunday, August 2nd, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.79 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,095 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $283. Antiwar.com reports NATO announced Friday that it has agreed to an Iraqi military request to launch a new program to help retain the nation's military and to help it reform its entire security sector. Iraq's military, trained by the U.S. and its allies during the occupation, has largely collapsed in the face of fighting with the Islamic State. The NATO training program will be conducted in Turkey and Jordan, according to officials, so there is, at present, no intention to permanently station NATO forces inside Iraq to conduct the training. That's likely to change, of course, as efforts to reform Iraq's security forces can't possibly happen entirely abroad, but NATO is trying to downplay just how big of a commitment they are making right now and will slowly escalate the mission. The timing of the announcement is believed to be related to Turkey's increased military involvement against the Islamic State, and the emergency NATO meeting Tuesday called by Turkey likely played a role in the decision to accept a long-standing request from Iraq. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Bitcoin Not Bombs. Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs offers premium publicity campaigns designed to facilitate an organization's adoption of Bitcoin as a payment system and to fully capitalize on that decision in their fundraising efforts. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com. UPI reports after refusing breakfast, a group of 42 maximum security inmates at Utah State Prison's Uinta facility announced a hunger strike and issued demands to state prison officials. In a press release, the Utah Department of Corrections described the group of inmates as documented gang members. Department spokeswoman Brooke Adams told the Huffington Post the inmates' demands include the release of various gang leaders at a different maximum security unit. She says corrections officials are currently reviewing the list of demands but declined to share further details. Prison officials have offered each participating inmate the option to undergo a health checkup in order to check weight and vital signs. The health of inmates will be monitored regularly by prison staff. Officials said in a statement, the department also has inventoried food items in each participating inmate's cell to document potential nutritional intake. The department will continue to offer the inmates meals as regularly scheduled. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Reuters reports the Attorney General of Texas has been indicted on securities fraud and other charges over an alleged scheme to mislead investors in a technology company, according to the New York Times and other media outlets on Saturday. The three-count indictment against Ken Paxton will be unsealed in Dallas on Monday when the former longtime state lawmaker is expected to turn himself in to authorities. Reuters could not immediately confirm the reports. The grand jury had been asked to determine whether there is enough evidence to indict Paxton, who came to office this year with a strong Tea Party support on first-degree felony charges. Paxton drew national attention when he said county clerks in Texas who object to gay marriage on religious grounds can refuse to issue marriage licenses to same-sex couples, despite the landmark U.S. Supreme Court ruling in June requiring states to allow same-sex marriage. When he was in the state legislature, Paxton was hired to seek clients by an investment firm called Mowry Capital Management, which is facing allegations from the state Securities Board of defrauding investors. The board found in May 2014 that Paxton was not properly registered as an investment advisor in his work with the firm. It reprimanded him and fined him $1,000. Paxton's name also appears in a federal court document as a major investor in a Dallas area firm in a U.S. Security and Exchange Commission investigation. Court documents in the federal investigation of the technology firm Servergy do not make any allegations of misconduct by Paxton or draw links to the investigation into the securities fraud in Texas. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
This is the Onion Week in Review. In light of reports this week of a Russian crime ring stealing 1.2 billion username and password combinations from internet users, experts from top security firms across the country reportedly advised Americans to refrain from clicking on anything at all. The nation's top security specialists warned individuals to actively avoid any scrolling or swiping on the internet, and further urged Americans, as an added precaution, to steer clear of buttons, keyboards, and computer screens altogether. In other news, an employer botches a job interview. A date's flaws are coming at a woman faster than she can rationalize them, and a going out of business sign thanks a neighborhood for 3 months of no support whatsoever. Whether or not this video news summary eased the pain of your existence, you can now take solace in the fact that you're a few minutes closer to departing this meaningless world. For more, keep checking theonion.com.
This is the Onion News Network.
It is Free Talk Live. and you can join us here. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Lots of discussion about drugs tonight. The war on drugs, war on marijuana specifically, but also we've gotten into heroin, the supposed gateway drug theory, and more. With you in the studio, it's Ian.
And Mark.
And we're going to go right back into your calls and thoughts. And then if we get the chance, we'll talk about some things the libertarians don't understand, at least according to Raw's story. And is this a new piece, Mark? Because it does sound kind of familiar to me. Check the date on that one. I'm just curious. Also, the war on chalk escalates. All right, good to know. The war on chalk escalates. If we get a chance, we'll cover that too. You can see that story over at freekeen.com. But first, back to the phones and the fun. We'll talk to Scott, listening in South Carolina. Scott, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark.
Well, I'm in South Carolina right now, but if I understood Keith correctly, there's a basement available in Des Moines.
You're referring to the guy who is kicking his own daughter out of his house at age 20. Go ahead.
Yes. Great show tonight.
Thanks.
Never been a drug user.
You don't drink?
I do believe. Oh, I do. Yeah. Okay.
Okay. You're a hard drug user, Scott. Come on.
Yeah,
just saying.
Habitual.
All right.
Got a bad habit.
All right, go ahead. Sorry, I totally derailed you there. I apologize about that, but go ahead.
Yeah, you did. First of all, my heart goes out to Carl, and I want to address one thing he said. You know, he said, well, I work nights and I was away, and, you know, it sounds like he's beating himself up. You know, people are born with individual personalities and unique personalities, so you can't really do that. You might see somebody do something really bad, and you say, well, how was that kid raised? And you find out they, you know, they had three siblings that are perfectly fine. So,
yeah, that's a good point. You're referring to the caller. I just want to keep recapping here for everybody who's just tuning in right now this hour. You're referring to a call last hour. It's a tragic story of a son, a teenage, early 20s kind of son who fell into the heroin crowd, and obviously, a parent is going to look at themselves in a situation like that and say, you know, what could I have done differently? Was I somehow at fault for this?
Sure.
And I think that you're right. I mean, you can raise a child in as best a way as you possibly can, and that doesn't mean that they're not going to rebel against you, right? Like, you can raise them in the most...
My family.
Yeah.
And it wasn't necessarily a rebellion. It was just going another way, you know, so... Because the rebellion, you could take it personally, like they're rebelling against me. It's not that. It's just I want to pursue something else or try something else. But, you know, I think three of us agree that Prohibition was a dismal failure.
Yeah, it still is.
For alcohol, but...
It's still a dismal failure for everything else they prohibit, too.
But I want to address alcohol specifically in the 18th Amendment. I have to defend the process. And I have to defend the 18th Amendment, and this is why. It was a bottom-up, grassroots process. It was not a top-down, Washington decided, some senator had an epiphany or a congressman had a great idea that we should do this and that we should decree upon the land. This was a bottom-up, grassroots where, you know, certain groups of citizens persuaded enough of their other citizens to finally, this took a lot of work, a lot of effort. It didn't happen overnight. It wasn't done by lobbyists. It was done at the grassroots level, and it finally, you know, boiled up and got the required number of states to do it, and it was done that way. Now, eventually, they recognized that, hey, that was a mistake, and they repealed it. But I have to defend the process there.
I see where you're coming from.
Yeah, I see. I see there's value in what you're saying. But my question is that, I mean, really, is it better that, 51% or 65% of America decided that 33% of America couldn't live a certain way? I mean, is that good thing?
No, not necessarily. But I think I see where he's pointing out, though, is if they had to go through that same process to do that to cannabis, it might not have happened, right?
Like, had they. Well, like the way cannabis was made illegal is bull crap. If they could make alcohol illegal, they needed an amendment.
That was top down.
Right.
Yeah.
And I don't like everything is top down. The last 50 years is top down. You know, somebody decides and even the last 30 years, it's lobbyists that are deciding.
Right. I see what you're saying. At least that they were trying to, it seemed at least, follow the Constitution, at least the process.
Other citizens, even, and hey, you know.
Even though you could also argue that it was unconstitutional from the get-go because, well, if the whole point of America is to protect your right to pursue life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness, then obviously if I want to pursue happiness by having a drink, then prohibiting me from doing that and then further putting me in a cage if I do it is clearly interfering with my pursuit of happiness, right?
Agreed. Can I say something about synthetic pot? And I'd
sure.
Only get you guys on weekends, and then unfortunately we get minor league baseball that interferes with the show.
Yeah, well, it's radio, but thanks. I'm glad we're still on in Charleston anyway. Call the program director of the station and tell him thanks
I shall.
For hearing Free Talk Live.
I'll email him.
Cool.
Why do people smoke this
the synthetic
or bath salts and all this other stuff?
Because it's there.
I have an answer.
Yeah, go ahead.
I read it. It's not my original thought.
It's okay.
You know, there's a lot of people involved in drug court. People want to get high. They want to smoke
pot. Yeah, they do.
They want to smoke the leafy green stuff, which, you know, I'm not a smoker. But they can't because they're in drug court or they're on probation.
Right.
Or they're subject to urinalysis at work. So they want to smoke something that won't show up in their urine. And they're smoking this stupid, crazy crap.
Oh, yeah.
That makes you want to bite someone's face off.
Well, I don't know about that, but it's definitely some crazy stuff. I mean, there's no doubt about it. And I think you're right. I mean, your speculation is correct. The reason why the synthetic drugs are so popular is because they're there and they're available and because the other drugs are illegal. And so the manufacturers came up with the various different chemical variants
on. They're not subject to urinalysis. That won't be detected.
Right. And they're also not illegal, or at least some of them have now been made illegal, but then they can just go ahead and tweak the chemical structure and make another version of it and put that one out there until that one gets
made illegal.
And
they're not safe.
Yeah, and they're definitely pretty dangerous.
Can I ask one last thing?
Sure, quick.
Have you guys covered that 19-year-old from Indiana who had sex with a 14-year-old girl from Michigan?
No. Yeah, actually, we did cover that story.
You did? Yeah. Was I on the show?
Go ahead.
Is this recent?
Okay, good.
You can remind us, but I believe that I remember this story. Go ahead.
I just thought the judge's parole or probation conditions were ridiculous.
This is the one the judge that sentenced the guy for the hookup culture.
Yeah, the hot or not, you know, no internet for 5 years.
Yeah.
ATM curfew. You know, it's just ridiculous.
In wow.
Culture. Sex
wow.
offender registry for 25 years.
Yep. The mother of the 14-year-old, you know, said what happened, told what happened. The girl duped him.
She made it look like she was older.
Yep. The girl duped him, and the mother's like, please don't give him this sentence. Please don't.
Jeez.
But the judge is like, I'm sorry, I'm going to have to get you for this hookup culture. Hookup culture is disgusting. Wham, wham, wham. And, you know, just obliterated.
Thanks,
the kid.
Scott. I appreciate the
Thank
call.
You,
good thoughts here tonight. You must have covered that when I was off the show, Mark. That doesn't ring a bell to me at all.
Okay. Well, that's the story.
All right. Toll free number 855-450-FREE. The synthetic drugs are, a lot of them are really kind of scary things. And as I was pointing out with Dr. Ed Gogek earlier in the show tonight, who is a prohibitionist we had on in hour number one, these synthetic drugs probably would not exist if it weren't for drug prohibition. Because if it weren't illegal to acquire cannabis or MDMA or cocaine, then people would use those drugs instead because they're the real McCoy. They're the ones that the people who are using the synthetic drugs would prefer to use. But they can't for the various reasons that the caller suggested. And, of course, now the government's answer is to ban the synthetics, which isn't going to solve the problem either.
Don't forget the government's answer of guarding the poppy fields over in Afghanistan. You can go Google pictures of U.S. soldiers guarding poppy fields. Those poppies are being used to create heroin here in the streets.
855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. The live Sunday edition of Free Talk Live continues in moments. We have got time for you. More on the way. Also, you can join us via Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm, and this is Free Talk Live.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MY-TV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy. And get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MY-TV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional installation. You control what you watch, when you watch it. Record your favorite shows. Pause and rewind live TV. Even skip the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
Hi, I'm Derek J. To me, an activist's calling is to actively work to advance a cause. The cause for which I work is personal freedom. I believe my life is best when I engage in voluntary interactions and self-government. I reject the idea that anyone else has a higher claim to my life or my body than I do. I see people who call themselves the government as a threat to my personal freedom. I realize you may feel differently, but my relationship with the people who call themselves the government is completely involuntary. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. Live Sunday edition continuing here at 855-453. That's 855-450-3733. Hey, Skype into the show, and you'll sound pretty darn good when you do it. Skype username's lrn.fm. I'm grateful for all of our Skype calls tonight. We've had quite a few. And there's still a couple more to go here. Plus, plenty of room on the phones. 855-450-free. If you're online, you really need to protect yourself. Your own internet service provider is likely logging the websites you visit, the search terms you enter. Criminals sniffing out your Wi-Fi packets, that's a possibility too. But those things are not possible when you have ProXPN, because ProXPN is a global virtual private network that encrypts your data connection And that means that there will be no prying and spying after you get connected to ProXPN. You can do it for free. Just go and download their app for Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, as well as Linux. Get set up, get connected. You are good to go. Then when you're ready to upgrade to get their premium account with unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world you can access, you can privately torrent and get past regionally blocked websites, ProXPN will get you that package for 50% off the regular monthly price when you buy their annual account with code FTL50. Breaks the price down to around $5 per month, and that's good for the lifetime of your account. Code FTL50, like Free Talk Live and 50. You get it all with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee, and ProXPN does not keep records of your online habits. ProXPN.com/FTL with promo code FTL50 and get a great discount on privacy that is priceless. We go back to the phones and the fun. Armed Truth is on the line via Skype in Southern California. Go ahead, Armed Truth.
Hey, how's it going? Can you hear me?
Yes. Go ahead, sir.
Yeah, I just wanted to call in. You know, everybody's talking about drugs and everything tonight.
Yes.
But about the drug war and how it basically is perpetuating the drug usage going on. I used drugs and sold drugs, prescription drugs mainly, for a long time. But it's just getting worse now with the doctors prescribing. I know I have friends, painkillers so easily. Primarily opiate painkillers, then stopping, and then they turn and they keep using because the withdrawals and they're addicted and turn to heroin, begin to use heroin after that. And I have friends who've gotten in trouble for using heroin and doing bad things, you know, using it, getting caught with the police and everything. And then instead of getting them help, which, you know, the reason they're using heroin is because a doctor was giving them opiates and stopped, they instead of, you know, going to treatment and helping, they throw them in jail, which I have multiple friends who it's basically ruined their lives. They had careers and jobs and
everything
was lost. But if it was legalized and monitored, A, they probably would have never even ended up down that road. But at least then I feel like if you get caught with just drugs, nonviolent, you didn't hurt anybody, and you have drugs, and C, instead of going to jail to help them, to get them off it, because I know the example you guys used earlier about the crack addict and the meth addict who were given the choice of, you know, $20 or using pure crack. I could see with crack how they would not choose to use it. But the problem, my big issue is primarily with opiates, is that you have to have it, because when you wake up in the morning and you don't have it, you can't function. You're throwing up. You can't move.
No, I see what you're saying. What you're pointing out is that heroin is a physically addictive, seriously addictive drug, and in withdrawals, it's
pretty much
a real thing.
Undeniably the most destructive drug. When you sort of, you know, lay them all out on the table and look at what the reactions
no,
are.
No, I'll give you that. But what the study showed that you're referring to with the hospital environment and the crack and the meth users was that it's the incentives that drive the abuse. And so it's likely that those heroin users started using heroin not because their life was great, but they started to abuse that drug because that's how they were handling their problems.
With better incentives and perhaps a methadone regimen, those people could get off.
Yeah, and methadone's good. Suboxone is what I used. Mm-hmm. That was very good as well, but you have to use that in a controlled way because the withdrawals from Suboxone are 10 times worse than heroin, but it does help in the short term. I got clean voluntarily. I couldn't take it anymore. But yeah, I just think that that's what needs to be done. You send people into the jails and the prison systems, and it just perpetuates it, because especially if people are using it because they're depressed or they hate their life, and you put them in jail, and then it's hard to get a job. You basically screw them, and they say, well, you know, F it. I'm going to just keep using
it. Get high. Time to get high. Got nothing to live for at this point. Can't get a job. Keep getting back in on violation of probation. Why bother doing anything else? Yeah, you're totally absolutely right about that. Thank you, Armed Truth. Appreciate it. And Armed Truth there on Skype. You can join us there as well. The Skype username is lrn.fm. We've got Steve on the line. Steve, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, can you hear me?
Whoa, you are way too loud, Steve. You're going to have to back way off that microphone. And I don't even know if that's going to fix your problem.
Is this better?
Maybe. Try again.
How's this?
Yeah, I'll tell you what. I'm going to put you on hold. We'll work with you, see if we can iron out whatever the difficulties are that you're having. Quick recommendation for Skype. So with the Skype, we don't have a call screener here. It's us in the studio. We literally are just answering calls on Skype and putting them on the air.
I don't think any other show takes Skype calls, though.
I don't know. Maybe somebody out there does.
I haven't heard anyone do it.
So we're just putting the calls on the air. Please, we don't have time to screen everybody on Skype. Usually what we'll do for screening is just type in, hey, what do you want to talk about? You know, where are you calling from? What do you want to talk about? And we don't actually check the audio quality. We should. We probably really should check the audio quality on everybody. But literally, it's me and Mark here in the studio, and we're sort of doing the job of producing and doing a radio show at the same time. So do us a favor. If you're going to call on Skype, Skype has this handy feature called the Echo Test Service. Go ahead and install Skype, get it, you know, configured, and then run a check by calling the Echo Test Service. Then Skype will say, like, ding, hello, this is Skype. Talk to me or whatever, and then you say things, and then after 20 seconds or something, it stops the recording and plays that back to you so you can hear what you sound like to the person on the other end. Whether you're calling us or you're just going to call your friend or whoever it is you call on Skype, it's good to sound good. So take the time and jump through that process. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Whether you want to discuss the war on drugs, which, you know, the insanity continues on that front and will... I don't know if it's going to continue through our entire lives. I sure hope that it comes to an end. I sure hope that we can have some sort of a mass awakening on this issue where people can somehow find compassion and they can put aside their fears. Because the doctor that we had on in the first hour of the show was definitely trying to use fear to sell the idea of continued prohibition. My God, the teenagers! Teenagers might use marijuana more if we have legalized pot, even though there's evidence that shows that they won't. He claims he has evidence that shows that they do. So everybody's got
their
evidence. It
makes more sense to me. I mean,
I've always been, use it?
Yeah, I've always been surprised at the evidence that says
why?
That marijuana,
it takes away the forbidden fruit aspect.
I'm just surprised at it, Ian. You know, my experience would have been that, frankly, I'd have to say that marijuana use in teenagers is probably superior to alcohol use, that there's probably fewer... psychosis-related marijuana incidences than there are, alcohol-related deaths in teenagers.
Yeah, for sure.
So if you were to weigh them one or the other, then it would seem to me that would still be superior. But I'm just surprised when I see these studies, and they seem to be all over the place. They certainly show a relationship to marijuana legalization and crime, too, in California. There's another study. Studies all over the place in this.
855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live.
It's a terrifying thought. You're trapped somewhere without a radio and no access to GCN shows. A doctor's office. The DMV. Your mother-in-law's.
Come on, stay for dinner.
That's what makes the newly redesigned GCN Live app a true lifesaver. Listen to your favorite GCN hosts and programming on your smartphone, wherever you are. Download yours free on iTunes or Google Play. The new GCN Live app. Don't leave home without it.
Affordable health insurance was the promise of Obamacare, but for many, the government mandate caused more problems than it solved. And I want to tell you about a truly affordable alternative, Liberty HealthShare. Liberty HealthShare bypasses doctor and hospital panels, giving you the freedom to choose. 100% coverage up to $1 million per year per occurrence, which includes dental, vision, pharmacy, and holistic care. Call 1-800-714-6993. 1-800-714-6993. 1-800-714-6993 today.
Are you suffering with hearing loss? Are you sick of people constantly complaining that your TV is too loud? Are you tired of asking people to speak up? Would you like to hear more clearly, but you don't want to wear a hearing aid that makes you look old? Then you need to try Listen Clear, a life-changing breakthrough precisely designed by top audio engineers to fit your ear almost invisibly. And you can adjust Listen Clear to find the perfect way to hear everything, wherever you are and whatever you're doing. And now we're extending our in-home trial to let you try Listen Clear risk-free for a full 45 days with free shipping. We'll even give you free batteries for life. Call now, 1-800-956-9829. Listen Clear is lightweight and completely hassle-free, and it's practically invisible. Call for your extended 45-day in-home trial with free shipping and free batteries for life. For free information, call now. 1-800-956-9829. That's 1-800-956-9829. 1-800-956-9829.
Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross has been sentenced to life in prison with no possibility of parole. Now, an appeal is Ross's only chance, and he needs your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Oh yeah, here we are. It's Free Talk Live. Our toll-free number is 855-453. You can join us here. You can join us on Skype. Skype username, lrn.fm. Lots of people availing themselves of the Skype tonight. We can talk about the war on chalk coming up, if we get the chance. And things libertarians don't understand. There are apparently 7 things on that list. There's no way, even if we started it an hour ago, that we'd finish all 7. That's one of the things. We should probably start that at the beginning of a show. So maybe we'll get to some of that, or we'll continue it tomorrow. Either way, we do this show 7 nights a week. By the way, we're live. You can join us online anytime at freetalklive.com. So please do that. And you can support the show by becoming a Free Talk Live amplifier over at amp.freetalklive.com. AMP stands for Advertise, Market, and Promote. If you like what we're doing here on Free Talk Live and you want to help us get on more radio stations around the country and more satellite signals around the world, you can become an amplifier at amp.freetalklive.com. It's $5 a month. That's it. You get perks. You get access to the AMP-only call-in lines, AMP-only podcast, the AMP-only Facebook group, and more. Go and get signed up and help us get on more stations to introduce more people to the ideas of liberty, because there just aren't any shows on the talk radio world scene talking about ending the war on drugs. Are there? Are there any other shows out there doing this?
Yeah, they probably touch on it, but, you know, there's some people out there,
are
right?
Are there really? Who are the syndicated hosts?
The war
hosts?
On drugs?
Who are the syndicated hosts arguing for the end of the war on drugs besides Michael Dean of the Freedom Fiends?
Probably marijuana prohibition, certainly. There's somebody out there that's arguing for that, right?
Yeah, maybe like Larry Elder or something like that. I've heard he's got a new show.
I don't know. I mean, I got nothing for you.
Yeah, nobody's got. I mean, you're going to.
Neil Bortz did.
He's not on the air anymore.
No, he's not.
855-450-FREE, that's the toll-free number. We continue here. We're going to give Steve another shot. I checked him during the news, the break there. Steve, in wherever the heck you are, Omaha. Steve, are you with us?
I am. Do I sound okay?
Yes.
Excellent.
Go ahead.
All right. Well, thank you so much, Ian, Mark. Both of you are inspirations to me and all you guys up in Kingman, New Hampshire. I plan to join at some point. I'm going to visit in the next couple years.
Okay, cool.
For sure.
Well, you can join right now if you want the Free State Project. You're referring to the idea of moving 20,000 liberty-minded people all to the same place. The Free State Project's official move doesn't begin until they reach that 20,000 signer number, and then there's a 5-year window of time in which those 20,000 have to move. So if it's your intention to join the Free State Project at some point in the future, just go ahead and join ASAP. That way we can get one person closer to 20,000, unless it's not yet your intention you want to visit first.
I do, but I'm pretty convinced, and you're probably right, I probably should sign up. But, you know, what I wanted to bring up was I recently turned 30 years old, and Ian and Mark, thank you, Ian and Mark, both
congratulations
on
survival.
Yeah, right? That's one thing to be grateful for. And one thing you guys have helped me with is my perspective on education. I've been in college for way too long now. But turning 30, I was like, you know, what do I really want to do? What do I want to be known for? And something that came to my mind is I've always been, you know, I'm glad Mark was able to make it, because I feel like maybe Mark and I are kind of the sci-fi geeks, maybe kind of outer spacey. And I've always been an outer space enthusiast. And so I started looking into it. I've done some calculus. I've completed some chemistry. And I looked into it. And I looked into some things. Are either one of you familiar with SpaceX?
Yes, yeah, sure. That's the independent program that funded the rocket launch into orbit, right? Like the private rocket.
They just recently had a mishap.
Yes, correct. Yeah. Elon Musk, you know, alleged libertarian, runs it, and he has been successful in reducing the budget of the NASA launches. Astronomically himself in such terms. But it can be done. I'm convinced it can be done for even less. There was a Vice video article, magazine article on a company called Copenhagen Suborbitals. I don't know. Does that ring a bell for either of you guys?
I haven't seen that, no.
Okay, well, basically, they were looking to send their claim. One of the guys, there are two Danish guys. One of them was a metallurgist, or is a metallurgist, and the other guy was a NASA engineer. And they were pretty sure that they could send a rocket into low Earth orbit with a human being on board for about $60,000.
Wow.
Yeah, and I looked into it, and I think this is very feasible. And, you know, like, this is what I think I kind of want to do, you know, with my life, the kind of a purpose. And it's something that I think I might be able to help bring to liberty. You know, I think there's like this technology and science enthusiasm in the liberty movement. Do you guys agree?
Oh, yeah. There's all kinds of geeks in the liberty movement. Absolutely. But what is your vision exactly? To launch a rocket to do what? Take tourists up? Or what are you looking at doing here?
Well, to be honest,
because Richard Branson's already planning to do that, right? I'm not saying you shouldn't compete with him, but he's got a lot of money.
Yeah, that's the truth. Well, you know, looking at it, I guess I tend to be, I like to be cautious in my mentality towards what can we use technology for? What can we use high technology for? And something that is always present out there are these natural threats. I remember Mark talking to a caller one time. Mark was talking to a caller about global warming, and Mark said, well, you know, a volcano, a good sized volcano could go off and we get the exact same effect as what climate change, you know, alleges. And the same is true of some of sort of astronomical cosmological threats. Things like near Earth objects. I know that's kind of a different term, or potentially hazardous asteroids. But I think this is something that liberty people, I propose, could do and could encounter, interdict. It's something I think that
just to clarify,
share.
You're saying you would try to interdict on an asteroid coming towards Earth by like blasting a rocket at it or something?
Something like that. There are many different ways. There are many different perspectives, methods on what to do about these threats. I think it can be done for a very affordable price, for a price that's far less than what NASA likes to project. And I also think it can be done, you know, if the priorities are right. And the priorities are kind of right now. If you look at the market, the way that NASA does, it's weird because all those tax dollars go to NASA and then NASA decides what the priorities are. Mm-hmm. But maybe You know, I like to think that libertarians have their heads on a little bit straighter, that they know what the priorities are a little bit more clearly, that they process that a little bit more clearly. And so what I want to do is I've went ahead and I've set up a website and I've set up a Facebook group. The website is, it's just all one word. There's no www. There's no www. All you have to do is go into that address bar and type in libertyspaceinterest.com.
You can't put a space in a you can't put a space in a URL.
Oh, right.
Oh, you mean the word space.
The word
Sorry.
Space.
Okay, Liberty Space what?
Interest. .com. Just put that into the address bar. It takes you a very simple web page. But my goal is I'm glad all these callers are here tonight, because it sounds like people are listening. And my goal is to get a survey, some kind of idea. Anyone that's out there in the libertarian community, the liberty movement, that's interested in this kind of thing, I think home students would make a great homeschooled students, private school students would make a great asset to this kind of thing. But any enthusiasts, any professionals that are interested.
So is the idea to have people who like space stuff sort of get on board and rally behind the cause of your vision? Is that what you're looking for?
I want to go live on one of these near-Earth objects. I mean, like, get me away from these people. Let's set up an atmosphere on one of these things, and then we don't have to, you know, Earth's going to have a heck of a time, you know, putting its government on that one of these near-Earth objects. There's
Wait a
huge
minute. He's not talking about colonizing something. He's talking about shooting down asteroids
sure.
or whatever.
That's something that there might be a demand for, but so far we haven't been hit by one of these objects.
Yeah, it'll be that's gonna be a tough one to test the system on, right? It may be too late if you fail at it. I don't know, it's an interesting concept, Steve. Good luck with it, and thanks for your call tonight. I appreciate it. So there you go.
I want to go to 433 Eros.
By the way, I would have given the feedback with him on the line, but we're short on time here. We're continuing with one more segment. When you're making a website, don't put white text on a yellow background. Just, I don't know about you, but it doesn't look good. 855 450 free. It's Free Talk Live. More coming up.
If you could choose any school in the country to earn your college degree and be on your way to a better life, would you choose one the Wall Street Journal recognizes as producing some of the best qualified graduates, or one the Princeton Review ranks as a leader in undergraduate education, or maybe one the U.S. News and World Report names among the most innovative schools in the country? Now, you don't have to choose. At Arizona State University, we want to help you learn to thrive in life. At ASU Online, we offer over 100 graduate and undergraduate programs on your time and schedule. You receive the exact same curriculum, degree, and prestigious faculty as the on-campus students, and we're universally recognized as one of the innovators in online learning technologies. For information, call 1-800-595-9736. U.S. News & World Report ranked ASU in the top 10 best places to earn an online degree. So learn to thrive with ASU Online. Call today at 1-800-595-9736. That's 1-800-595-9736.
If you owe $10,000 or more to the IRS or state in back taxes, you know they'll never stop coming after you. With bank levies, wage garnishments, they'll even seize your home or business. The good news? A government program for tax debt forgiveness. It's called the Fresh Start Initiative.
I'm Paul Sibley. With U.S. Tax Shield, we can help navigate the new laws, get you protected, and resolve your tax issues permanently.
Call the experts at U.S. Tax Shield now for your free consultation and get a guaranteed quote to resolve your case. Call 800-436-6451. That's 800-436-6451.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on doing the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more.
It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Free Talk Live. We got time for you if you want to join us here in these remaining moments of this, the live Sunday edition. Our toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And Skype in at Skype username lrn.fm. We just got off the line with Steve, who is in Omaha. He's got a vision for space exploration, or I guess not really just exploration, but shooting down threats to the Earth. Mark, you were saying you're not really too concerned about it.
Not concerned with near-Earth objects, but I think that there are people that are concerned about them.
Yeah, so there might be a way to fund a project of his vision, perhaps.
I suppose. I mean, I don't
know. The problem is, libertarians, they don't have a bunch of money. So you probably, you know, your best bet as far as, like, raising money for space-related projects is to go wider than libertarianism. I mean,
oh, yeah.
The libertarian market is so limited. There just really aren't that many libertarians out there, period. And of them who, you know, do exist, there are very few who have any disposable income whatsoever to be able to fund anything to any significant extent. That's been my experience. I mean, maybe we just know the wrong people, Mark, but that's just my experience.
So I had previously said that I was interested in sort of colonization of near-Earth objects, you know, like Eros 4. I think it's 433 Eros is what it's called. Another one's called 1036 Ganymede.
Are these just space rocks?
Basically space rocks, yeah.
Okay.
And from what I can tell, nothing on them of any import. Surely there's an asteroid out there that is of some import, but, you know, these are just rocks. But one thing that I keep on getting drawn back to every time I get excited about a near-Earth object, you know what we need? We need a, you know, basically a natural Death Star. If we could just have this rock, then we'd be able to move it around and stuff. It'd be awesome. I love the idea. But the fact is that the world's oceans are less explored than outer space.
Ooh.
Outer space has a siren song that draws people right now, but
yeah, that's a good point.
I mean, you know, it'd be a heck of a lot easier to create your own little city out on the water with resources, right? Like, you know, here's an idea. If you had a catamaran upon which your family lived, and you decided, oh, I don't know, let's call it a 40 or 50-foot catamaran. Let's go 50 feet. Be nice and safe. 50-foot catamaran. What are we talking about here? $300,000, $400,000 to purchase one used. And if you spent a couple hundred bucks on fishing equipment, there you've got free food for a long time, right? You go out in space. No free food. There's no algae to fish out of the water that you could eat.
That space ice cream is going to get real tiring after a while.
You had to pay to bring it with you, too.
Yeah.
And, right, like sails, they provide free locomotion. No free locomotion in space. This is one of the reasons I like every time I get excited about space, I back off.
But when you say the oceans are unexplored, you mean underwater, right?
It's like true, underwater. But I mean, honestly, think about how big the South Pacific is. Mm-hmm. It's gigantic. And the governments aren't coming out there to bother people. If you wanted to create your own little libertarian colony, you really could do it out in the South.
Didn't they try that once and the King of Tonga showed up with a gunboat or something like
Minerva,
that?
Minerva, yeah, but the Republic of Minerva, you can go look that up. But I would recommend something that floats. That way when the King of Tonga shows up with his gunboat, you say, okay, bye-bye, and you leave.
Or maybe he says, get off that boat, it's mine now.
When was the last time somebody said that?
Because he's the government. He can do whatever he wants. Maybe he likes your boat.
Okay.
Maybe
he wants it. When do they do that?
He's the king.
I get
a
that.
Real king.
No, he's not a real king. The United States is the biggest government
around. He's a king
around.
With a gunboat. You don't have that, buddy.
Oh, I see. You're talking about me being King Mark the First. Indeed. As king, I choose not to to aim any guns at anybody. All my subjects willingly sign up on board. No,
I'm saying brought you back to that. Said it yet tonight.
What I'm saying is that you probably can create even a floating landing craft for airplane. You certainly there's seaplanes that could service this area. It makes a lot more sense to create seasteads than it does to make space steads.
It certainly would be cheaper. Yeah. That's for darn sure. Let's go to Howard. He's in Philly on Skype. Hello, Howard.
Hi, gentlemen. Thanks
Welcome.
For taking my call.
Yes, sir.
I want to make some comments about what people callers earlier were saying about addiction and stuff. I can see a point like where the gentleman who has a daughter that he finds is being lazy and not motivated, and she's just sitting around smoking weed, that he might have made the right decision to make her life a little harder, bring her bottom up, and get her off her ass to work. Because
by bottom you mean this is an addict's term for when things get bad. So a bottom is, when a situation where the addict strikes reality and it's an unpleasant reality.
Right. Where they have to face their life, that they either they motivate themselves and start doing what they have to live, or
it's
they
tough love.
Don't live anymore. Yeah.
Tough love.
I know your experiences, Mark. You've been through your own stuff in a much harsher way with prison, but you turn your life around. But addiction is a tough thing. You know, it's like, I wouldn't wish it on my worst enemy, really, because I've struggled with my whole life. Like, I started smoking pot when I was in fifth grade. And the first time I smoked it a few times before and it never affected me. But the first time I got high, I like dropped to my knees like a native, like on an island. And I was bound to a god. Like, I love getting high. That is what a thing about me. Like, I just like to escape reality. So. Am I a bad person? No. I mean, I'm a good guy. I mean, I don't hurt people, but that's something about me. I like to escape, and I think more people should be more understanding. Like, I can see that addiction and a person that isn't living up to their responsibilities is not good. But, you know, people keep it hidden. There are so many people who rely on chemicals just to get through their daily lives. Like,
sure.
Caffeine is a chemical.
It's huge addiction.
You know?
It's huge.
It's a stigma. Like, so to just like to say, oh, he's a crackhead or she's a junkie, or to discredit them, it really bothers me. Because like if somebody says, oh, she's a crack whore, that's somebody's mother. You know, that might be your brother or your sister. People have problems. So I really don't like it when like people discount others just to say that they're an addict and they're useless, because it's not. People have problems, you know. Depression is like, I wouldn't wish that on anybody. Like, people who are trying to raise families who are struggling with depression, like, they don't wish it on themselves, but it's an issue they have. Like,
Howard,
it's a thing. But
thank you, man. I appreciate your call and the thoughts tonight, as always. Skype username there, lrn.fm.
One of the first things I think of when somebody talks about somebody having an addiction to drugs is the level of trust that I'm willing to put in that person. When somebody has an addiction, I'm thinking of crack, crank, heroin. My concern is, you know, not their, you know, what their value is as an individual. My concern is because I think they have value. I mean, those people have value. My concern is that will they tell lies and are they trustworthy? Because oftentimes they're bound so deeply to that addiction, you just can't trust them. And, you know, the times that I've chosen to trust addicts, I've often been, I've been sad that I have.
Yeah, they will certainly disappoint you.
They'll disappoint themselves.
Yeah.
If they're willing to disappoint themselves, then what about me? You know, I'm down on the list of people that they, want to achieve things for. We had a good friend who worked at the radio station who threw away, you know, a great career as a program director for an oldies station. And
addicted to, God, what was it?
I think it was crack.
That's right.
But whatever it was, it doesn't really matter what it is. All these things, have similar results. And, you know, last I heard, he was bagging groceries. It's sad. It didn't need to be that way.
All right, so tomorrow we definitely want to talk about the this list of things libertarians don't understand.
What about your war on chalk?
The
can war you squeeze
chalk.
That in?
Yeah. So freekeen.com, you can go and see the video of the chalk removal process. What happened was there's a local guy here, Ed, who is a liberty-friendly guy. He was working at actually the Republican booth at the county fair. He decided to do something nice, and he chalked some hopscotch squares out in front of their booth. And sure enough, kids and adults alike were utilizing the squares as they were walking around the county fair. He came and told us about it. And of course, I had some chalk in my trunk, so I went out and got some. And Derek J. chalked some hopscotch squares out in front of our place. And 20 minutes later, the park administrator came by and told Derek J. that he needed to remove it. And then ultimately, you know, I went and I talked to another person at the park, and that person said, well, it's fine with me. I think it's a great idea to have kids doing hopscotch. But this other lady comes back, and the really tough part about this, and maybe we'll talk more about it tomorrow, was hard for me because the lady who was enforcing this on us, who ultimately made us remove it and then came to remove it more herself, gets along with me. Like, her and I have had a great relationship until this moment when she became this sort of power-hungry bureaucrat almost. See you tomorrow night, freetalklive.com. Keenvention is coming up October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. Explore Keen, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel from 2013 on. This year, Activist of the Year Daryl W. Perry and Chris Cantwell will be keynoting. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 30th through November 1st. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or pay with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallo Keene Costume Dance Party. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more speaker announcements or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info. Keenvention.info. So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Liberty Conspiracy is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Sunday, August 2nd, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.79 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,095 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $283.
Antiwar.com reports NATO announced Friday that it has agreed to an Iraqi military request to launch a new program to help retain the nation's military and to help it reform its entire security sector. Iraq's military, trained by the U.S. and its allies during the occupation, has largely collapsed in the face of fighting with the Islamic State. The NATO training program will be conducted in Turkey and Jordan, according to officials, so there is at present no intention to permanently station NATO forces inside Iraq to conduct the training. That's likely to change, of course, as efforts to reform Iraq's security forces can't possibly happen entirely abroad, but NATO is trying to downplay just how big of a commitment they are making right now and will slowly escalate the mission. The timing of the announcement is believed to be related to Turkey's increased military involvement against the Islamic State, and the emergency NATO meeting Tuesday called by Turkey likely played a role in the decision to accept a long-standing request from Iraq.
FPP Radio News is brought to you by Bitcoin Not Bombs. Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs offers premium publicity campaigns designed to facilitate an organization's adoption of Bitcoin as a payment system and to fully capitalize on that decision in their fundraising efforts. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com.
UPI reports after refusing breakfast, a group of 42 maximum security inmates at Utah State Prison's Uinta facility announced a hunger strike and issued demands to state prison officials. In a press release, the Utah Department of Corrections described the group of inmates as documented gang members. Department spokeswoman Brooke Adams told the Huffington Post the inmates' demands include the release of various gang leaders at a different maximum security unit. She says corrections officials are currently reviewing the list of demands but declined to share further details. Prison officials have offered each participating inmate the option to undergo a health checkup in order to check weights and vital signs. The health of inmates will be monitored regularly by prison staff. Officials said in a statement, the department also has inventoried food items in each participating inmate's cell to document potential nutritional intake. The department will continue to offer the inmates meals as regularly scheduled.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports the Attorney General of Texas has been indicted on securities fraud and other charges over an alleged scheme to mislead investors in a technology company, according to the New York Times and other media outlets on Saturday. The three-count indictment against Ken Paxton will be unsealed in Dallas on Monday when the former longtime state lawmaker is expected to turn himself in to authorities. Reuters could not immediately confirm the reports. The grand jury had been asked to determine whether there was enough evidence to indict Paxton, who came to office this year with a strong Tea Party support on first-degree felony charges. Paxton drew national attention when he said county clerks in Texas who object to gay marriage on religious grounds can refuse to issue marriage licenses to same-sex couples, despite the landmark U.S. Supreme Court ruling in June requiring states to allow same-sex marriage. When he was in the state legislature, Paxton was hired to seek clients by an investment firm called Mowry Capital Management, which is facing allegations from the state Securities Board of defrauding investors. The board found in May 2014 that Paxton